For Saatchi and Saatchi.
You're gonna love this house, Sergeant Riley.
Just look at these high ceilings.
The upstairs is even better. You can read the Constitution from your window.
Upstairs? I don't see any stairs.
Just strap on this harness and climb right up.
Up this rock climbing wall.
There's no field manual for finding the right home. But when you do, USAA Homeowners Insurance can help protect it the right way. Like saving up to 15% with our claims-free discount if you haven't filed a claim in 5 years, even if you've been with another provider. Learn more today at usaa.com/insuremyhome. USAA. Discounts vary by location and may not be available in all states. Restrictions apply. Membership eligibility and product restrictions apply and are subject to change. USAA means United Services Automobile Association and its affiliates, San Antonio, Texas.
All right, now, it's time for your favorite show. It's time for the Kevin and Nikee Show on iHeartRadio.
Yeah.
It's time for the Kevin and Nikee Show. They gon' have it lit up. Yeah, you know, it's time for the Kevin and Nikee Show. They got the airwaves popping every city across the globe. It's time for the Kevin and Nikee Show. They gon' have it lit up. Yeah, you know, it's time for the Kevin and Nikee Show. They got the airwaves popping every city across the globe. You know him as a dope actor, Kevin Deepin. 360 twice, Jim, how you keep winning? And you know the baddest actress, Nikee Warren. She's so bad, you walking past, she had you speaking for her. If you ain't tuning in, this your reality check. You might miss out on your favorite star celebrity guest. When they celebrate, what you do, you get the bell, yeah. Throwing Kevin's corner, get inspired and encouraged, yeah. Bend them corners, why you listen, but don't swerve. Find out what's getting on Nikee nerves. What's bothering Nikee? What's bothering Nick? What's bothering Nikee? What's bothering Nick? Keep on playing. Me and Kevin Coons and we gon' get you hit. Yo, check us out on social media. In your mobile phone, we everywhere. You ever stations played out like a ringtone. Follow me like Beano, R-E-M-E-Y. Beano, Remy. Pop like Sammy. And my flow hotter. Think of Sammy. Been doing this since I scraped up pennies. But back to the subject, Kevin Nikee.
We are back. We are back. Yes. We are back.
Yes.
We're back for another exciting week, another exciting episode, another exciting show.
Yes.
It's the Kevin and Nikee Show on iHeartRadio. We're on iHeartRadio and all around the world. And I'm actor Kevin D. Benton.
And I'm actress Nikee Warren.
And Nick, we back.
Yes, we are.
Well, we always got a lot to say.
Yes, we do.
I mean, we are radio show hosts, so, you know, we got to say something.
Yep. You know what I'm
saying? So we always got a lot to say. That's all we do is say stuff. You know what I'm saying?
All we do is talk.
That's it. So we got a lot to say, a lot to talk about.
Yes.
And we're not going to waste no time. So with that being said,
yes,
it is now time for the many adventures of Kevin and Nikee.
Yes.
All right. So, Nikee, let you. Yeah, you had to give me an extra bell on that one. So let you go first then. So, you know, I know we always on the grind, always doing what we do.
It's been another, you know, exciting week, and I'm just so filled right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's just been awesome. It's just been awesome.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what you have going on?
So, I mean, you know, just auditioning, getting ready, you know, and just getting some rest because we about to be busy. We're about to be busy. So over the weekend we had it wasn't a table read, but it was like
a meeting. It was like a project.
Yeah, it was like pretty much a powwow, trying to wrap up Love Songs with the awesome director Rodney L. Cherry, you know, trying to wrap that up. Mm-hmm. And so we, you know, we had to do a little powwow to put some finishing touches on that. And that's going to be good.
Okay. Yep. Absolutely. That's going to be good. And it was nice to have that over a little grub.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Rodney. Yes. Yeah, with the treats. Yes. Yeah. That was awesome.
So yeah, we had the project meeting for Love Songs Weren't Meant to Make You Cry. And got an awesome talented cast. And, yeah, definitely looking forward to wrapping that up. And then we had an audition for a big project.
We had an audition for this. Really, we can't give it away. We can't say anything about it, you know, just yet. But this thing is going to be big, and it's going to involve some traveling.
Yeah.
So all I can say is get the passport ready.
Yeah, it's going to involve some passports. It's
going to involve some passports. But, I'm excited about that. I'm waiting to hear back from that. And, you know, the auditions are still going on. I think they're going to do what?
Well, from what it sounded like, from what you shared with me, and it sounded like we made it to the next round.
Yes.
Because the producer who I spoke to, he said he really, really liked me. He said, man, and I'm going to tell you what he said.
What
he said, you're going to be good because you talk a lot. He said, you're going to be good. You're going because you talk a lot. He said, you got the personality. He said, you got an interesting story.
Yeah.
And so he said, he asked me, did I fill out my application? I said, yes. He said, well, be expecting a Skype interview. That's what he told me.
Nice.
So the one you spoke to said something similar.
The one I spoke to, you know, she asked me, you know, tell me a little bit about yourself. Mm-hmm. And I told her that I was an actress and different things like that. And so she said, okay, tell me a little bit about, you know, your story. So as I was giving it to her, she was like, wow, that's good. Yeah, like, okay, Yeah, you know, as Kev, you say it all the time, as actors is being the best believable you.
That's right.
And so I said, if I can get him with this, she was like, oh my God, yes.
Yeah, so we're excited about that. And it's nothing, no better feeling than knowing that you prepared, because we prepared.
We sure did.
We prepared for our audition.
Sure did.
And, you know, every now and then, you know, some of these projects will send you, I guess I want to say a blurb or a synopsis or some questions you can think about going into the audition.
Right.
And it would behoove you to prepare and think about those questions. It's going to help your audition. And
you
so
you have to prepare.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't say it enough. You cannot walk into these auditions blind like
right,
that.
Right, right, right.
You have to do your research, and any questions that they ask you to prepare for, you got
to
do it.
And you got to be able to answer it.
You have to be able to answer the questions. You can't walk in there like, can't do that, because you pretty much put yourself out.
Right,
you
absolutely.
Know, before you even get to the next round, because that was round what, one?
Right. That's round one.
That was round one.
Yeah, that was round one.
Yeah.
And it was great, man. And it's no better feeling than walking out of there and having received feedback that they were pleased with your audition.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
and,
mm-hmm.
you know, mm-hmm. it's always like the cherry on top when they can tell you that you've made it to the second round.
Right, absolutely.
So we was grateful for that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man. And then this past weekend, you know, we was doing the last minute thing to get our taxes done.
I'm so happy. I'm gonna tell y'all what I did. I tried to attempt to do them myself.
Yeah.
You know, and it didn't come out right.
Yeah.
So Kev was like, listen, take them over to this place right here. Yeah. I guarantee you it's gonna be done right. And I took it over there and end up, you know, getting more money back than I thought I was going to get.
Right.
Me doing it myself, I had myself owing everybody.
Right, right.
But when she did it,
I
owe nobody. So I'm
absolutely
happy.
Absolutely, man. And it's like, it's just no better feeling, man, than knowing that, first of all, that you can have the peace of mind.
Yes.
That your taxes are done right.
Yes.
They're done with integrity.
Absolutely.
They're done by a professional.
Yeah.
And if you get audited or if, you know, or anything like that, you know that all your T's are going to be crossed
mm-hmm.
and all your I's are going to be dotted.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And so we also paid for the fee for the peace of mind.
Yes, we did.
So in case something do come back with an error, it don't fall on us.
Fall
on those. But here's the thing. You know what? I like that. So we're going to be putting a person out there who did our taxes. She's going to be eventually starting her own business, and she did a phenomenal job. She works for a organization mm-hmm. who does taxes, mm-hmm. but she recommended, she said, hey, do you guys want to purchase the peace of mind package, which yeah. means that if she's done any errors, it won't come back on us.
Right.
They pay up to $6,000 in fees. But that said to me, you have integrity.
That's right.
Because if she wants us to buy the peace of mind package mm-hmm. that all the weight falls on her exactly. and the organization, that told me that she did it with integrity, and that's what yeah. you look for when somebody does
your
taxes.
And that's what you look for. Absolutely. Yeah, so, I mean, I'm just happy that I don't owe anybody.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I'm just happy about that.
And to get some money back.
That's
a blessing.
Man. I mean, it is a blessing because, yeah. you know, when you own a house, you think you're getting the whole world back. And come to find out, you ain't getting nothing
right,
back.
Right.
I was in there pleading the blood. Like, can I claim the dogs? I mean, they're no longer
Can I claim the dogs and cats as children? You know what I mean?
Listen, because, you know, when you have animals, the insurance and the upkeep of that animal yeah. sometimes costs more than the insurance and the upkeep of you.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So can we claim some of these animals?
But you know what's going to happen, though.
I know.
You know what's going to happen.
I know.
Everybody going to have an animal farm in their house around tax time, then get rid of the animals yeah. after it's over. So they yeah. can claim them, you know, take pictures of them, yeah. count them, claim yeah. them, get the money, and then put them all out in the backyard.
I was trying.
Listen, I don't fault you for trying.
I was trying. But we don't want to be greedy.
Yeah.
We don't want to be greedy. I'm happy with what she gave me.
Right.
You know what I mean? What she got yeah. me back. I'm happy with that.
And then the thing that you can have peace of mind that it was done right.
Yeah.
And it was done with integrity. So,
and I don't owe the whole universe.
That's right. And so we hope everybody out there, man, got your taxes done. And hey, you know. Oh, I want to say this. Remember, Jez Mathis talks about this all the time.
What?
Remember all those people say I pay you back doing when I get my tax return back?
Yeah, you know
so
what?
You need to start targeting them people. Make your list of people who said they were going to pay you back when their tax return come back because it's now tax time. And so hopefully you'll get your money.
and remember this. We all know how people get when money is involved.
Yeah.
Don't beat them down if they don't have it. Just forget about it.
Right. Some stuff you just let it go.
Remember, we talked about this a few weeks ago.
Right.
Just let it go. If they don't have it, just whatever. Just, you know, not to let them borrow nothing again the next time.
That's right.
That's how they go.
Nick, you ever had somebody that they came to borrow your stuff and then they keep it so long, you got to borrow it back in order to use it?
You ever had somebody like that? Not only that, but you got
to
plead with them. Like, look, let me get it. Let me get it. I need it.
Right.
And it's yours.
Right.
Yeah, I've had people like that. Okay, yeah, just go ahead and keep it. I'll just let them keep it.
Just go
but
buy
you
it.
You ain't getting nothing else.
Right. You can't let them get nothing
else. You ain't getting nothing else.
But then that's your foolishness.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But anyway, we hope everybody
What's
got...
What's that saying? You fool me once, shame on me. You fool me twice, shame... No, you fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. That's how it goes, right?
And the third time, you're just a fool.
That's it.
Right.
You know what? You're going to hit me, jump up.
Yeah, man. So, man, we hope everybody got your taxes done and got them done with, of course, have them prepared with integrity and honesty so that, you know, you have the peace of mind and, you know, hey, man, it's all
apart.
And
we hope y'all didn't wait till the last minute.
Yeah, well, you know how we do. Most of us know we going to owe.
Yeah.
So you wait till the last minute so they don't start hounding you till a little while after
then
that.
You got a bunch of extensions going on. Yeah. You know, I got to apply for an extension.
Right.
Come on, listen. Y'all know every year, April 15th is the deadline.
Right.
So don't wait until the deadline, you know.
But it's too late now. It's past the deadline.
It's past the deadline. But I'm just saying, y'all know every year April 15th is coming.
Right.
So don't wait until April 15th to do it.
And you know what? And if you have somebody out there that you feel really comfortable doing your taxes or doing it with honesty and integrity, mm-hmm. stick with that person because you know what? The best marketing is word of mouth.
Yeah.
You know, when you've done a good job or someone's done a good job for you, what you go do is you go tell somebody.
That's right.
Say, hey, come here. You know what I mean?
That's how one person
helps the other. But anyway, we got a lot of announcements. We got some announcements coming up.
Yes, we do. You guys, I'm telling you right now, y'all got to mark your calendars for all this awesome stuff that we got coming up. If y'all don't listen, don't hit us up and say y'all didn't know because we tell you every week. I'm just saying the calendar is just hot like fire with everything that we got going on. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we got 5 short films, April 27th. That's in a few weeks. Doors open at 5. And let me tell you, this thing is going to be awesome. It's going to be at the Venice Island Performing Arts Center. And that's 7 Lock Street, Philadelphia, PA, 19127. Get your tickets. It's at info@fiveshorts.org. And I'm telling you right now, you will want to be there. Come out and support all of these directors who got together and created these films. And I'm telling you,
And I got to add that Nick is in 2 of the 5.
Yes.
Nick is in 2 of the 5.
Yes.
And she did a real, real good job.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to that.
One of the films is called Mama. Mm-hmm. That's going to be awesome. Remember we told you guys that's the one I had to do where I had to be schizophrenic.
Right.
Okay, I played a schizophrenic mother. And the other one is called Super Zero.
Okay.
Super Zero.
That sounds like about some superheroes.
Yes. Okay. I mean, that's going to be awesome. And I was the store owner. And, you know, they came up in my store talking that yin yang. And I had to get them.
Okay. All right. We're looking forward to seeing that,
man. Right. I'm looking forward to it. And the next one we have, Real Production Film Festival. That's coming up May 11th at the Kingbridge Lecture Hall in Newark, Delaware, 19716. Now, this is free, you guys. This is free. This is going to be awesome. And once again, I'm in one of these. Sleep is for the weak. And can I tell them?
Yeah.
Kev is going to be on the panel.
I'm one of the judges.
Yes. I cannot wait. Come on out. Now, like I said, it's free. May 11th. Mark this on your calendar. April 27th, May 11th. It's free. Come on out and have some fun with us. And next we got
May 30th.
May 30th. Positive Choices Breakfast with the Stars and Celebrity Day. Man,
yeah.
I cannot wait. This thing is going to be awesome. We're going to be out. We're going to be talking to the children. Kev, give them a little bit of
All right, so it's going to be at the Copeland Middle School. And we're going to go in there. We're going to be talking to the kids.
Going I cannot to wait.
Pairing up with other celebrities.
Yes.
And talking to them about saying no to drugs. And so last year, I got paired up with Jeffrey Owens.
Can't wait.
And looking forward to doing it again. And Nikee will be going this year and pairing up. And I cannot wait. You know what you're going to talk to him about?
I sure do.
Okay. Yeah,
I sure do, man. I've been going over it and going over it and going over it. So I'm ready. Now, that's May 30th.
Yeah.
So you guys get ready for that. That's going to be awesome.
Yeah, we'll keep everybody posted. And we'll post a flyer and things like that.
Yes.
And it's going to be real nice. And what they do is the day before, they have like a little breakfast or dinner or whatever with all the celebrities where we get together in this one room. And like I said, I participated last year, man. It was so much love and positivity. It's such a family oriented event. And then the following day they had this big assembly.
And
all the kids are there and the principal and, you know, some of the state dignitaries are there and the celebrities are there. And, they give out awards and they acknowledge people and all kinds of things. And then after that, man, before we did assembly, we go eat breakfast and then they announce all of us and all that stuff. Just kind of let everybody know who we are. And we go to the assembly. Then after that, we go to the classrooms and we just go, they pair us up with your partner and you go in there too. And they rotate us and you talk to the kids and encourage and inspire and motivate them about saying no to drugs.
Nice.
It's so much fun. Just knowing that you made a difference.
Nice.
Then we eat lunch with the kids. Then we do the second half for the classes that we missed.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the celebrity basketball game.
Nice.
Now, this year, I'm not playing with these kids, man. Because last year, you know what I'm saying? They was taking it serious, man. They was like, yo, we coming for you, man. I'm like, look, man, this is just
a
charity.
Don't be beating up on the kids.
I'm not playing with them this year. I've been training for a year for this moment, man.
That's a shame.
It's going to be a lot of fun just going out there and playing basketball against them, man.
That's
bonding and all that.
Yeah. So don't forget, you guys, mark it on your calendar. April 27th, 5 short films, Venice Island, Performing Arts Center, 7 Lock Street, Philadelphia, PA, 19127. Doors open at 5. You can get more information at info@fiveshorts.org. And also, do not forget Real Production Film Festival. It is free. You know we love free stuff.
You sure do.
May 11th, Kingbridge Lecture Hall, Newark, Delaware, 19716.
Mm-hmm.
Your girl is going to be in Sleepless for the Week, and your guy is sitting on the panel.
Yes, sir.
Don't forget. Come on out. And also, don't forget, May 30th. Positive Choices Breakfast with the Stars and Celebrity Day. We're going to be out. We're going to be talking to the children. And we're going to be the main thing. Say no to drugs.
That's it.
Say no to drugs. Yep. What else we got, Jeff?
Okay, and then on May 31st, we have the 12th annual Appreciation Day for Youth Academic Awards, mm-hmm. honoring student athletes from the tri-state area acquiring a 3.0 GPA nice. Or higher in addition to athletic achievement. Nice. Okay, it's going to be from 5 o'clock to 7 o'clock at Dave & Buster's, 325 Columbus Boulevard, Philadelphia, PA 19106. And it's all sports, 3rd through 12th grade. Must bring your report cards. Plaques will be given out. Free honorees. And general admission is $10. You can find more information about this. Contact Jamal Green at 267-978-8100 or retroactionsports at yahoo.com. That's retroactionsports at yahoo.com. And Jamal Green is a friend of mine, a Philly b-ball legend. Mm-hmm. And we're going to try to get down there and support the kids. Nice. Got to support the kids with academics and athletics. Yeah. And, you know, they always talk about how the kids are out here doing negative things. But these are kids that are excelling mm-hmm. in the classroom mm-hmm. and on in their respective sports. Mm-hmm. And so we want to we'll keep you posted about that. And then on June the 14th.
Nice.
We got the Recession web series, okay? Super talented writer-director, Maurice Paramore, mm-hmm. Who we had on our show, is going to be having the Recession web series on June the 14th. It's going to be at the Burlington County Library Auditorium, 5 Pioneer Boulevard, West Ampton, that's W-E-S-T-A-M-P-T-O-N, New Jersey, 08060. And then last but not, oh, and I'm in that.
Kev is in that.
Now listen, I play a character.
Yes. Come on out and support.
Come on out and support. And come out and network.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Come out and network. My brother said something to me that's so true, and it's paying off big for Nikki and I. He said, sometimes you're going to have to go to these networking events mm-hmm. even when you don't feel like mm-hmm. it. So, mm-hmm. yeah, come out. You never know who you'll meet.
Never know.
We get cast in a lot of stuff going out to networking events. So they want that. You know, they say, hey, we're in everything. This is a small reason why. Yep. You know what I mean? So we want to invite you to come on out and network. Show your face in the place. Bring your, what's that, business cards.
Bring your business cards. And your resume.
And your resume sometimes. Yeah, keep your resume. Because as we say, this is a relationship-driven business. And then last but not least, I got to give my man 50 grand pots and pans. Chimsal Balarbi from Algeria.
Yeah, y'all.
All right? He's our friend. He's our brother. Friend of our show. He did our movie poster for The News mm-hmm. and for Honor. You want to check it out? You can go on our IMDb pages to see what it looked like. We also posted it on our Facebook pages. But Chimsal messaged me this past week, and he told me that he got interviewed mm-hmm. by a very, very notable newspaper in Algeria.
Nice.
And he said that he mentioned the Kevin and Nikki show as people who helped him put his message and his work out to the world.
Shout out to
Chimsal Balarbi.
He gets a bell. He gets a bell. Yes.
I asked Chimsal, I said, well, can I see the article? And he gave me the article.
He did.
He gave me the article. I got the article. I can't understand none of it. Why? Because it's all in Algerian language. But I'm going to post the article and just thank them anyway.
You know what? We can post it. And then post a translation of it.
I'll translate it. But he did mention the Kevin and Nikki show, our brother, Chimsal Balarbi, always hailing from Algeria, man. And he does great work. So if you need a movie poster done for your short film, feature film, or you want to have one redone.
That's right.
You want to reach out to Chimsal Balarbi on Facebook, C-H-E-M-S-O-U. Last name, B-E-L-A-R-B-I. And keep in mind, gang, this is his craft. This is his profession. This is his business. And he does great work.
Yes, he does.
So, yeah. So, that's all the announcements we have for right now. Mm-hmm. We're going to be announcing them on every week to you know, as we get closer to keep you reminded. Are. And, come on out. Network. Come on out and show your face in the place. You never mm-hmm. know who you'll meet. You never know. Hey, we've got cash just going to networking
events. Yes, we have.
And
yes,
we have. It is a relationship-driven business, we always say. And so we're excited.
We're excited.
Yeah, we're excited.
All and right. I just can't hide it.
I just can't hide it. What's the
name? I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it. Oh, yeah. You know, see, it don't take much to get him started.
Well, that got anything off?
That's it. That's all the adventures I got.
Yeah, other than that, man, we both just stand on the grind.
Yes.
Stand prepared, stand ready. And, hey, man, when opportunity meets preparedness, man.
That's it. That's
it. You never know what'll happen.
That's
it.
That's it. And we've been working out because we trying to get up in Marvel.
Oh, yeah, no question.
For real.
Oh, no question.
We've been working out, making sure our bodies are tight and right because when Marvel come calling, we going to be ready.
That's it.
Yes.
That's right.
That's right.
All right. So we're going to take a break.
We're going to take a break. But before
we do,
man.
Listen, y'all, when we come back.
When we come back.
Y'all are going to want to hear our special guests who are on the line.
Yes.
Oh, man. Super talented celebrities, legends.
Yes.
Y'all going to want to hear their story.
I cannot wait.
About what they're involved in the industry. And, you know, it's just hard for me not to say their names.
Don't do it.
But I'm trying to describe them. But I'm doing the best I can to describe it without giving it away.
Yes.
We're going to give it to y'all when we come back.
Yes.
Listen.
Yes.
Don't go nowhere. Don't touch that dial. When we come back, y'all going to hear from two of our special guests.
Awesome.
It's the Kevin and Nikee Show on iHeartRadio. We on iHeartRadio and we all across the world. We'll be right back.
I'm satisfy your sweet tooth with some tasty treats from the brownie shop. Fudge cupcakes, sweet potato pie, freshly baked bread, homemade ice cream, creamy chocolatey brownies, and much, much more. Check out their full menu on Facebook Brownie Shop or Brownie Shop 2019 Instagram. Get your next dessert from the Brownie Shop. Your sweet tooth will love you for it.
Urban Elite Beauty Shop is an online urban beauty supply store that serves both men and women in the urban communities. Our goal is to offer a wide range of beauty supplies at wholesale prices that encourage consumer feedback and build lasting relationships. We will leverage the exploding trend of male home beauty solutions, i.e. male units, baldness solutions, and much, much more. Go to www.urbanelitebeautyshop.com today. Check out what the urban experience is all about. Anyway,
get on my nerves.
All right. Anyway,
yes.
We are, but you gotta love Marvin Gaye.
Love me some Marvin
Gaye. Yes, sir.
How could you not?
You know what? That was an excellent selection too, given who our guest gonna be too.
Of course.
Oh man, that was right in line. Nick the DJ, man.
Come on,
Nick the DJ, man.
You know MC Skillet, guys.
MC Skillet.
You know. I hold it down.
Yeah, that was a good like kind of. You know,
yes.
It's like that was like the pre-sermonic hymn, as they would say in church lingo. You know what I'm saying? And the you next know. Voice you're going to hear. You know.
MC Skillet got it.
Good selection. That was good.
I hold it down. You know how I do.
That's it. That was an excellent selection.
Yes.
Given who our guests are going to be.
Exactly. All
right. So we are the Kevin and Nikee Show, and we are back.
Yeah.
And we're excited about our special guests. And, I'm going to start off by saying he hails all the way from Camden, New Jersey.
Yeah.
He is the CEO of Soul Records. He has produced many great artists on the Soul Records label, Mighty Works Media, and Erskine Entertainment. He's the associate producer of Chase Street television series, which is making waves around the country.
Yeah.
And he is one of the actors who plays the judge. He also plays the judge in Mob Diaries. And guess what, y'all? He's a judge in real life.
Oh, yeah.
He is a bar associate member, graduate from Rowan University and Seton Hall University, School of Law School. So you don't want to get in trouble.
You don't want to get in trouble.
But if you get in trouble, he might get you out. But hopefully you won't get in trouble. But he is also the former owner and co-founder of the McDade Records Corporation, former model in the Job magazines, Black Romance and Bronze Thrills magazines, former professional boxer, so he'll knock you out.
Yeah.
And then pick you up. And he's a former school teacher.
Yeah, so he's going to knock you out, pick you up, and teach you
and
a little
teach
something.
And then teach you a little something.
That's how that go.
Yeah. And then next we have...
Yeah, listen. She hails all the way from Hamilton.
Oh, I didn't say the name.
You ain't say his name.
I ain't say the name. It's none other than Mr. Robert E. Johnson.
Woo, he got to get the bell. He got to get the bell. Yes, yes. And now check this out. She hails all the way from Hamilton, New Jersey.
Yeah.
She is an actress and a model who is signed with Erskine Entertainment Management. She plays the court clerk in Chase Street and regularly attends John Pilata acting classes, who is a student of acting and always enhancing her craft. She is also a self-employed super talented website designer and developer and much, much more. I'm talking about none other than Lauren Marie. Woo! She got the bell too. She get the bell too. Woo! Yeah.
Yeah, what's up, guys?
Hi, guys.
Yeah.
Hey!
Yeah, how y'all doing?
Lauren is such a great, fantastic actress that ever signed with Erskine ones.
Absolutely.
Rob, we didn't start the interview yet, man. Don't worry, we're gonna let you talk, man. But wait, before we get started, we always wanna thank our special guests and the celebrities that come on our show for taking time out of y'all busy schedule.
Yeah.
And so thank you guys so much for coming on the show and sharing with us, sharing with our listeners. You guys are fantastic, intriguing artists, and entertainers, and entrepreneurs, and they are really going to enjoy hearing y'all's story. So thank y'all.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow. Lauren, you sound like you lost your voice.
A little bit, love. My allergies got to me.
Okay. All right.
What's that flow nays? Wow.
That's okay. All right. So look, we're going to jump right on in. All right. So let's start with Rob.
Okay. Let's start with Rob.
So Rob, I mean, you are the CEO of Soul Records.
Yes.
Or might I say the legendary Soul Records. Mighty Media Works and Erskine Entertainment. For those that don't know, please tell our listeners about Soul Records and the legendary artists like Gladys Knight and the Pips that have recorded on your label.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Soul Records is a record label that was established by Barry Gordy in 1964. It was part of the Motown Record Corporation. And Barry had recorded some of the great hits on Soul Records. As a matter of fact, Gladys Knight and the Pips, you know, recorded I Heard It Through the Grapevine on Soul Records.
Yeah.
She recorded Midnight Train to Georgia on Soul Records. Junior Walker and the All-Stars, he recorded all his music on Soul Records, like Shotgun. There was a dance called the Shotgun.
Yeah. My mom and dad used to do that.
Okay. Well, that was on Soul Records. And not only that, every record that came out of Motown was backed up by a group of musicians called the Funk Brothers. They was established by a guy named Earl Van Dyke in the Motown Blast, which only recorded their music individually on Soul Records, but they backed everybody that ever came out of Motown.
Okay.
Diana Ross, Smokey Robinson, all of them. Marvin Gaye produced one of his greatest hit records by the Originals, which he wrote a song called Him and Barry Gordy, daughter, which was his wife, Anna. They wrote a record called Baby, I'm For Real, which was recorded by the Originals.
Mm-hmm.
That was also on Soul Records. And one of the great records on Soul Records was recorded by Shorty Long called Here Come the Judge.
Yeah.
Remember that record from back in the day.
Back in the day,
Soul Records is a real legendary label. And what I did was when I acquired the label, you know, Cheryl Anderson, the director of communications for Soul Records, is also the number one Hollywood reporter. She penned an article called Resurrection of Soul Records.
Oh, okay.
Those of soul never dies. So, you know, we're keeping the legend of soul alive, which is part of Motown.
I also am
in the process now of also doing the TSOP trademark, which I have artists, which would be the Sound of Philadelphia.
That's it.
Now, one of the groups that's on Soul Records, Exclusive Soul, and Exclusive Soul is recording artists are Walter Johnston and Ryan Gibson, who's also part of it. And, you know, we had one of the soundtracks in Chase Street. And he's also going to Vegas. He's having a going away party this evening where he's performing with Exclusive Soul at Time Out, which is in Barrington, New Jersey, this evening. And he'll be taking the TSOP to Sound of Philadelphia to Las Vegas.
Oh, okay.
And, that's nice.
Yeah. And when you mentioned Mac Dad Records, you know, Mac Dad Records was the label that me and my brother Fred had started back in the 80s.
Okay.
And, you know, we had a lot of hits back then, like Do You Want to Break Dance and some of those records. So that was one of the other industries, you know, and companies that we had started. And, of course, Mighty Works Media, you know, we do turn-ups with Gilly the Kid and all the different hip-hop artists.
Right.
And we publish, and, yeah, we have quite a few good with me on that. And my history go back far when it comes to the film industry. You know, because I mean, I was on the set when they did the first Shaft.
Okay, okay. Do we need to start playing that Shaft music right now? Okay.
That almost sounds a little like Shaft, and I put that together myself. And you know, I was just talking with a good friend of mine, which everybody knew, Leon Huff. You know, he's talking to him the other day because it was his birthday. And, you know, he's a fantastic piano player. You know, he did Backstabber, you know, or Living for the Weekend, and all those hit songs that he wrote, him and Kenny Gamble. They got 3,000 hit records. Can you imagine that?
Now, Rob, for our listeners that may not know who Gamble and Huff is, you got to explain who they are, because these are legends. The Sound of Philadelphia. Explain who Gamble and Huff is, so our listeners would know. We know, but just somebody that might be listening might not know.
Yeah.
A bunch of charter schools.
Yeah.
And Leon Huff is from Camden, New Jersey.
Right.
And the two of them guys met each other back in the early 70s, 71, and they developed a company called Philadelphia International Records, PSOP, the Sound of Philadelphia.
Yeah.
I remember when Don Cornelius did at the song train. He came to Philly looking for somebody to put some music together. Huff and Gamble put together an instrumental called TSOP, the Sound of Philadelphia. They were going to call it Soul Train, but Don Cornelius, for some reason, didn't want to call it Soul Train. Didn't he wish he had of? When you hear Soul Train, the original Soul Train music, that's Gamble and Huff MFSB Orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
So they didn't hire by Motown or Soul Records. So they came back to Philly and started Philadelphia International, the Sound of Philadelphia, and they created 3,000 hit records from that day until now.
Nice.
Jones won. Patti LaBelle, she signed with a Lou Rawls, "You'll Never Find Another Love Like Mine."
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. God, you remember that or not?
Mm-hmm.
But that was one of the things that they put together. And you know, they did a lot of soundtracks. Even for the love of money, Donald Trump used that for his TV show he was doing. So you know, for the love of money.
Right. The OJs. That's right.
Yep.
The OJs.
Yep.
Yeah.
Now you.
Awesome.
Now
awesome,
you know
awesome.
What? That's.
Yeah.
That's a lot of.
Area.
Okay.
Now that's a lot.
Hold on for 1 second. Hold on. Yeah.
That's a lot of rich history there. So when you come across new artists and they want to work with you, do you educate them on just the history of the label?
Yeah, definitely. Absolutely. Like Drew Zak, he got a record out right now. You probably seen Michelle Obama doing a Jimmy Twist on Jimmy Fallon show. Yeah, on he was the first new guy I put out. So on his record's called Drew Zak Shimmy Twist. It's on iTunes, Google Play, all that stuff. And on the back of the CD, it had artists before Drew Zak, and it explained all of the writers, Smokey Robinson, Stevie Wonder, all the great writers, Barry Gordy that wrote for Soul Records, and it also has all of the artists that was on the label before him. And Jimmy Ruffin, you guys may remember, recorded a super hit record back in the day called What Becomes of the Broken Hearted.
Mm-hmm.
That was on Soul Records.
Yeah, I know that song.
I definitely educate them about it because a lot of people don't know it, but even last year, I think when Drake got the award for maybe the best song or whatever the deal is, they had to call McFadden's right-hand son, Gamble and Huff, because sampled and used their music.
Right, he sampled it.
He sampled it, yeah.
He sampled it.
He was the one that created that song.
Right. Cool. All right, so awesome. That's awesome.
That's really
awesome.
That's what a lot of music. You know, even right now, Tatiana Taylor got a hit record out that was on Kanye West's label, and I had to contact BMI in reference to the royalties because Poochie Hart from the Delphonics, you know, that was his song. They even got his voice in it. You know, so he's being taken care of. You know, he called me up for some help. You know, he's a good man.
Okay.
You know, so I took care of it for him. You know, and when you mentioned I was a judge, and I do the mock trial judges for New Jersey.
Okay.
You know, and I'm also, I put a lot of innocent cases back to court on post-conviction release. You know, I'm talking about, you know, good hundred. And I was just talking with a friend of mine earlier about Willie Gary. I don't know if you know him or not. But, you know, he's a friend of mine who I know well. And Willie Gary, there was a guy who had went to Disney Corporation to try to put up a Disney World in Florida. So what happened is Disney said they weren't interested.
Mm-hmm.
So then a few years later, they came back and they developed the whole thing and put up Disney World. So he got Willie Gary and told him that, you know, that was his whole idea and concept. And they sued Walt Disney for $10 billion. He got Johnny Cochran to work with him on the case. And so they settled it for $395
million.
Wow. So, you know, yeah, so sometimes you never know who the creator of something is who actually came up with the initial idea.
Right.
Some other people, like I have a friend from...
Hold, Rob. Yeah, so I just got to interject. So you absolutely right, you know, because there's a lot of sampling going on. And so, yeah, they have to go back and they got to pay the royalties or get the... So there's no copyright infringement. But we want to go to Lauren real quick. Yeah, hold on for 1 second.
Yeah, we want to go...
Yeah,
we want to go to Lauren. So, Lauren, you are an actress. Tell our listeners a little bit about how you got started in acting.
Hi, guys. Well, I just want to say thanks for having me on your show.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thank you. I got into acting actually just for something fun in the beginning, and then talent was drawn out of me from my acting teacher, which he's located in Philadelphia, John Pilatus Studios. So kudos to him.
Yeah.
There you go.
I just took a liking to it, and I'm just rolling with it, and it's taking me to unbelievable places, and I'm very blessed and grateful.
Nice.
And I'm grateful for Mr. Johnson, and Kevin, you're awesome. We've done a couple things together.
Yeah,
so
thank you.
I'm grateful for you and meeting you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Awesome. Now, like, we pretty much do our research on our guests, not in a creepy way, as we say, but you're very, very photogenic. I would have to nickname you the selfie queen.
Wow.
You know, because you take selfies.
Thank
you. Yeah, you're very photogenic. So, you know, you do the acting, you model, and then you play the, judge clerk.
Mm-hmm.
In Chase Street. So tell us a little bit about your character and what was that experience like?
Without giving it away.
Yes, of course. Well, it definitely was out of my character. I was a very serious person. I had to play that role. And normally I'm funny and goofy and always laughing. So that was definitely hard to hit, but fun to conquer. I feel bad putting away the bad guys.
Wow.
You don't have to feel bad putting away bad guys.
You really don't.
Right? There's a lot of twists to it. It's hard to explain because I don't want to give it away, but I'm grateful if I enjoyed the experience, and I think that it's going to be a phenomenal series, a big success and hit. It's based upon a true story of the political drama in Camden, New Jersey, and I'm from New Jersey, so
okay.
I'm grateful to be a part of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And I'm grateful
that is just
Johnson
awesome
for bringing me on board with that.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Now you, I mean, you take acting classes.
Mm-hmm.
You take your craft very, very serious. You play the judge clerk. Was there any research that you had to do to prepare for the character, or did you have a basis of knowledge, say perhaps from watching Judge Mathis you know, maybe a court TV show. Tell our listeners about how you prepared for that character.
Okay. Unfortunately, I didn't have any knowledge.
Okay.
You know, you hear things here and there, you know, people would get into some court issues, but I wasn't privy to it. Mr. Johnston took a lot of time with me, as well as me researching judicial things, laws, New Jersey laws in particular.
Mm-hmm.
We've even went to libraries and archived old cases to reference against so I can learn inside and out. So it was tedious, but it was fun and also a learning process. Maybe in my next lifetime I'll come back as a lawyer. Who knows? But it was definitely interesting, and a lot of research was put towards the back end.
Yeah.
Awesome. So,
yes. Yeah, now you said that you don't want to send them to jail, but you know, of course, you have to send them to jail. So when you do that in your character, are you laughing a little bit, or are you sending them to jail for real?
But I'm like, oh no.
But you know, and Lauren, I love what you said, and that's what a consummate professional would say. She talked about research. And you know, it's that's right. It's okay. And then she also talked about how Rob gave her information. So some of the best knowledge that you're going to get about maybe a character is going to be from your research, or who could better tell you than the judge himself, Rob E. Johnson. You know what I'm saying? So you had a good basis for knowledge, of gaining knowledge. And I'm almost certain that your character came out believable, and I can't wait to see it. And I can't, this Chase Street thing is just making waves.
It's making a lot of waves.
And yeah, we want to talk about that.
That's just awesome.
It's important to, I think it's important to research any part as a character that you play, because you are feeling it, you're living it, you're understanding it, and you're going through it. So that draws a better actor or actress.
And it does. And it does. It does.
What you need to do.
See, that's a student right
and
there.
And the research helps bring the character
that's right.
out.
Because the last thing you want for somebody is to look at your performance and say, a judge clerk would never say that or do that.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Right.
And like we talked about the top of the show, me and Nick, it's about being the best believable you.
Awesome.
So yeah, we want to come back to Rob. We got to talk about Chase Street, Rob.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
You know what you were just saying. Chase Street, the court scenes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Laurie was phenomenal as a court clerk. You know, he couldn't get a better court clerk on the planet to do that.
Well, she had a good teacher as well, so that
she
helped.
She sure did.
I appreciate that. And the court scenes, if Chase Street, every attorney and prosecutor in the court scenes are actual attorneys.
That's what I heard.
I was getting ready. Yeah.
That's what I heard.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I heard.
Now, Ken Gardner playing a prosecutor outside a U.S. prosecutor, you know, who was not, he was one of, as a matter of fact, he's worked in entertainment too, who's an actual great actor, you know, for those scenes outside. But in the court itself, the cases that we do in court in Chase Street are performed by actual attorneys. There's Gary Burke, who's also a Bar Association president. He's in Chase Street as one of the defense attorneys.
Mm-hmm.
Juan Gonzalez, who's one of the instrumental ones in having the Puerto Rican parades.
Mm-hmm.
He plays a prosecutor in Chase Street. Corey Leffer, who's an attorney, a great, great criminal defense attorney, she also plays a prosecutor in Chase Street. Kenny Aida, who's one of the instrumental attorneys for bringing justice to a lot of wrongly convicted defendants in New Jersey who have been set up by the police, with some of these scenes are actually in Chase Street. He's also played a defense attorney in Chase Street. So Ross Gigliotti, who's an attorney, great attorney from New Jersey, he's also an attorney in Chase Street. So all the attorneys, you know, Rick Asolta, another attorney who's also a judge, he's in Chase Street. So all of the guys who are in Chase Street are actual attorneys. You know, Law and Order can't touch Chase Street.
Now I have a question.
People, Law and Order,
We got you. We got you. Now, Rob, we got to ask this question.
Now, I have a question. So why did you guys put in actual, like, lawyers and judges and different things like that, as opposed to going and getting, actors? Yeah. Like, why did you guys do that?
You know what? That's a good question. But, I'm associated with so many attorneys. Rocco DePerz, he's an instrumental guy in Chain Street, and he's actually an attorney, too. But what it was when they came up with the court scene, since I was going to be the judge, I just wanted to have the best attorneys that, I could possibly find. And guess what? They're all great actors.
Mm-hmm.
They're phenomenal actors. And let me give a little bit of history about the Chain Street situation, because, or the story. Danny Brown from Camden, who was in the Basketball Hall of Fame. He was the creator of Chain Street. This was something that he put together, came up with. And then Thomas Freeman, who has books like The Organization and Her Little Secret, which is a movie, he wound up communicating with him and became one of the writers and the forerunners of Chain Street.
Mm-hmm.
And then Tom got hold of Nate Banks Sr. and Nate Banks Jr.
Yeah, and B.
Started people off like LL Cool J, Fresh Prince, Queen Latifah. They have a documentary called Hip Hop Spring Migration, which has every hip hop artist there is in it. So them two, and then Benny Mateo, he came on not only, as one of the executive producers too, he also came in as one of the great actors. He plays ex street hood, becoming mayor. All this is based on some stuff that actually happened. Everything is facts.
Mm-hmm.
And so when they got the story together to make everything completely realistic, and knowing that all these attorneys were available and they all can act,
okay.
It couldn't have been a better blessing than that. Matter of fact, we have a lot of actual individuals playing actual parts,
Okay.
Actual couple of guys from Philadelphia, PA is in it, who plays police officers, and then one of the individuals that Laura had brought to the board to me, he's also in it, Rodney Jones, he's a forensic guy. We have, guys who visit the store, he's a construction owner from The Sopranos, Clifton Powers. And
Pinky.
Terrell Hicks, he's one of the reporters from Bronx Tales. So, Nicole Martin, she's playing in it. She's one of the artists with Erskine Entertainment. Neva Vives, she's in it. She's playing a Agent Green. And she's been in Fight Valley, where she played in Two Tales of Wolf Boy. Take Two. A million other movies before she came on Erskine Entertainment. Mm-hmm.
Right. Well, Rod, let me interject right here. And I have to say that, I saw the trailer. It was phenomenal. It was definitely authentic. And you can tell now that we're getting the inside scoop that these, actual actors are really real life forensic folks and police officer.
Yeah.
And you're a judge. It's causing for it to be a very, very authentic and believable story.
Mm-hmm.
Not to mention that it's very, very well written, well directed. And I got to give a shout out to Denny Brown.
Mm-hmm.
Like I look young, but I'm a old school. I'm an old head. I look young. Now he was before I played ball too. He was before me, but I was right after him in his era of basketball. And like you said, he is one of Canada's finest.
Mm-hmm.
Hall of Fame, Mr. Get Buckets himself. I remember him, DeWine Wagner. They was like one of the top teams in the country. And they was beating everybody around the country. And so, you know, I have a special place in my heart for those that hail from the basketball fraternity. Mm-hmm. And then you want to throw in that he's a very, very, educated, and he's a very, very, Chase Street is well written, is well directed. And, you know, from my perspective, you get extra privileges if you play
That's
ball.
Right. That's right. Get the bell. Get the bell. That's right.
I went to his induction to the Hall of Fame.
Okay.
He was inducted into the Jersey Athletics Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
You know, a couple guys on Canada was inducted. You know, Art Steele. You know, he got a Super Bowl ring.
Probably Milt Wagner. I'm almost certain Milt Wagner mm-hmm. was Dwayne Wagner's pop.
Wagner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And Mike Rozier won the Heisman Trophy. So he's another local Cameron guy that was inducted and into the Hall of Fame. You know, Cameron had a lot of great guys. Even when Muhammad Ali came to Cherry Hill, you know, he came to Camden to train. You know, he boxed from guys in Camden that could box very well.
Right.
And so he had a great group of sparring partners from the city.
Right.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna say this, man. Camden does not have to take the back seat in terms of definitely not sports, basketball, mm-hmm. football, mm-hmm. boxing. So yeah, Camden doing their thing. But Nick had a question for Lauren.
What I want to do real quick before I go to Lauren.
Okay.
I want to ask Rob about distribution because Shea Street, you know, is getting big out there. So I want to talk a little bit about distribution. So
wait, he might not be able to put that information out here, but I guess we can ask.
Without giving it away.
I won't all communicating with us about everybody from the top to the top.
Okay,
awesome,
all right,
awesome,
that'll work.
Awesome.
That'll work.
Okay.
Everybody, whoever decides to act them up the best.
Okay.
The thing about it is they all know, no matter what, we are making it happen.
Right.
That's what I'm talking about.
Right.
Nice.
Everybody pitching in, and Nate Banks and Big Nate, little Nate, he knows how to make a mountain out of a molehill. He's a great guy. You know, they're all related to me too.
There you go. Wow. Well, listen, I definitely want to take some time out to give a shout out to the whole entire production team of Chase Street cast, crew, anybody that's affiliated and associated with that. We didn't get a chance to make it out to the premiere that was in Cherry Hill, but I did follow the story and the pictures, mm-hmm. and it was sold out. It sold out, and so it was great. It was great. But you
Three times.
So Nick got a question for Lauren.
Yeah, I got a question for Lauren. So yeah. Lauren, you're in Chase Street. So tell our listeners a little bit about what else outside of Chase Street you got going on.
As much as you can give away.
Without giving a lot of stuff away.
Well, there's three other things in the works. Two I'm almost in completion with. Mm-hmm. And then one, it's funny, there's irony behind that. I wish I could fill you in, but later on I'll be able to. We are starting something soon. So
nice.
It's a cumulative of four things. So I wish I could share and elaborate more, but when you're under a contract.
Right.
That's right.
Awesome.
But I'm very busy. I'm grateful.
That's right.
I know that's right.
Respect the contract.
Now, one thing I can say, which, you know, I mean, I can't name the name of the series or anything, but, you know, you guys may be familiar. She's going to be playing a character in one of the horror series.
Oh, yeah, we know which one it is.
We know.
Yeah.
We got some mob series that's coming out of New York that we're in communication with this week.
Nice.
Awesome.
And that's going to be some top of the line. What's going on with that? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
And top known popular actresses.
Okay.
That's okay. And hey, that's what. Okay. Hey, listen, that's what you look forward to. Like when I was playing basketball, I wanted to know where are the best players playing, and so that's where I went. Because that's the way you find out who you are and what you can do. And in order to be the best, you got to be around the best,
that's
and you
right.
got to beat the best.
That's right.
So I had a, absolutely. So yeah.
That's right.
So I had a question. Question. That's right. I had a question for Lauren. So Lauren, you're a phenomenal talent, student of acting,
mm-hmm.
and you know you pursue it very, very seriously and professionally. But you also are a super talented web designer and developer. Tell our listeners a little bit about how you got started doing that and things of the sort.
All right. Well, I like to help people out, and I'm all about small businesses and bringing money to them because that's what this world needs more of.
Wow.
And I started a company called Smart Small Business Solutions, and anyone that is listening is welcome to go on and just state that they heard me pitch this and they could get a great percentage off. I help small businesses with designing websites, building websites, and bringing traffic to them, making them be seen and visible.
Mm-hmm.
Most people nowadays go on the internet for everything. That's the way of our world, unfortunately. And, you know, if people aren't privy to having a website and they only have a brick and mortar, that's where me and my company comes in, and we help them and we bring customers to them and their business drive. So I've been doing that for 3 years. I'm grateful. I love it. And that's really all I got.
Awesome. Awesome.
That's awesome.
Awesome. Yeah, and you know, especially as an act, you know, us as actors and actresses, you know, one of those things on our list, along with headshots, resumes, our portfolio is a good website.
A good website. That's
right.
It's
a good website. So at the end, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So yeah. So at the end of the interview, we definitely want you to, you know, put your website out there, and hopefully, it'll, you know, some people who may need a website built, actors or actresses, because agents and managers, agents and managers take you more serious
when
you have good headshots, a good resume, a website, and you're on IMDb.
Yes.
With a picture. On IMDb with a picture.
With the photo.
That means you're investing in your craft.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
You know, I look at it as this. A website, when I go in and I explain to my customers like what I'm going to do for them, I explain it very simple. I state, it's like we're a car and we're driving down the highway. And there's a beautiful billboard, and your website is the billboard per se.
Gotcha. I like it.
I love it.
I love it.
Simple, right?
Yeah,
I love it.
No traffic going down that highway. No one's ever going to peep out your store.
That's
no
right.
Or what you do, and that's where we come in, and we help them, you know, the best that we can. So
that's right.
Awesome.
Yeah, you heard it here first, guys.
Listen, y'all are getting Y'all are getting information that you would have to pay for free right here on the Kevin and Nikki Show.
Yes.
We are talking to the infamous CEO of Soul Records and much, much more, Robert E. Johnson, and the super talented actress, model, web designer, web maker, builder, however you want to word it,
Lauren Marie.
And you're getting it here on the Kevin and Nikki Show.
And when you hit her up, serious inquiries
only.
We cannot stress that enough. Be serious about your craft.
All right. So listen, guys. Oh, man.
Yes.
Listen, this interview has been so much fun. We definitely got to have y'all guys back.
Because
we got so much more we want to talk about.
Yes.
But all good. What did it say? Good things have to come to an end. You know what? I read a quote.
You know that's a song.
Well, I read a quote by Lauren that said, nothing lasts forever.
That's right.
That was one of her quotes that she had. Yeah. So we wish that this interview could last forever, but unfortunately it can't.
on the back of some of our soul shirts, we got the soul never dies.
There you go.
That's
I like
right.
that. Well, look, let's combine it right now. Listen, the soul never dies, but nothing lasts forever. So yeah, but listen, man, we definitely want to. We definitely got to have you guys back, man. You've been phenomenal guests. We got a lot more we want to talk about.
Yes.
And as me and Nikee always say, when you come on the Nikee show, y'all guys are already family, but when you come on the Kevin Nikee show, you're family.
See, y'all family so much, he getting tongue-tied.
Thank you, Kevin. Yeah. You're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome. Y'all so welcome. But listen, before y'all leave, we'll start with Rob. Rob, put your social media out there. How can people follow you? Websites, Instagram, whatever it is that you do, so that people can follow you.
Well, they can follow me. I'm on Facebook under Robert E. Johnson with the Soul logo.
Okay.
On Instagram is Erskine52. My website for Soul Records is soulrecordsllc.com.
Nice.
There you go.
Now, I'm in the process of redoing the Mighty Works Media one. Now, all my artists at Erskine Entertainment, any mail or anything that we get, that's at Erskine Entertainment, Soul Records, or Mighty Works Media, P.O. Box 632, Camden, New Jersey, 08101. And my number, in case you're interested in my great artists, like, for instance, Lauren, who's one of the greatest actresses on the planet. You can contact me at 609-880-3207. And, I have all her information. She'd be available. She's getting ready to take the world by a storm in a minute, when she come back from New York.
Nice.
That's what's up.
I got an old saying, I can't make something go wrong if I try to break it.
That's right.
I like it, Rob.
That's right.
And as far as the website, which I know she's the greatest in the world at that, you guys can ask her. She can give you all the information. All
right. Well, we're gonna ask her right now. Lauren, put your social media out there, your website. If people want you to build a website for them, they want to book you as an actress, put it out there. Take your time and put it out there.
All right. Thanks, love. My website is www.smartsmallbusinesssolutions.com.
Mm-hmm.
And my Facebook is Lauren Marie, and my Instagram is official Lauren Marie 29.
Nice. I like it.
And love it.
Anything
love it.
Else, Mr. Johnson's
got. That's right. Love it.
All right.
Yes, thank you guys so much.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you guys so much for coming on our show. Yes.
One day.
Absolutely.
And both of you guys are such great actor and actress.
Thank you.
And you guys are the world's greatest, and I know I tell this to everybody, but I mean it when I tell you, you're the world's greatest host.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank y'all. You guys are so welcome.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, see you. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your day.
All right. God bless. Man, they were awesome. They were awesome. Oh, my goodness.
Awesome sauce.
In every way.
Awesome sauce.
Just awesome in every way.
Awesome, man.
Awesome in every way.
Man, listen. I hope that people will appreciate the legend, the entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
The students of their craft.
That
we had on the show.
Yep.
You're talking about.
Yep.
The Sound of Philadelphia.
Sound of Philadelphia.
Soul Records.
Yep.
This is the legendary Soul Records.
Mm-hmm.
You know, our listeners heard the names.
Absolutely.
He was throwing out that recorded on this record.
Absolutely.
We were talking to the CEO of the legendary Soul Records.
Yeah.
And I mean, I wish we could have talked a little bit longer. He kind of serves as an agent too. We left that part.
I heard. He sounds. He. You know what? He gets the bell. Yes.
That was all tough.
You young artists looking to, come up. Listen. Yeah. You gotta be serious because this man is serious about his stuff.
Rob is that dude, man. He's that dude. Yeah, he's serious about his business, his craft.
I'm telling you right now, he ain't signing just anybody.
He's not signing just anybody. He's not signing just anybody, and I don't blame him. It makes me think about what Will Smith said.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be bringing something to the team that the team needs.
That's right.
So you have to be bringing something to the table. You know what I'm saying?
And he ain't about that foolishness.
He's not about no fools. He's about his business.
He's about his business.
Yep. And that's why we said serious inquiries only. And things like, we normally don't let people put their phone numbers out, but we want to come behind that and say serious inquiries only.
Serious inquiries please, only.
If you know you can't rap, don't try to slide them a CD. I'm serious, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying because you always got that person that want that handout, that want to get the hook up, you just started rapping last week. No. He got professionals on his label.
Yeah, and listen, make sure you do your vocal strengthening training and different things like that before y'all going up in there trying to sing for him.
Right.
He'll let you know.
Right, that's right.
Not right now.
That's right. maybe work on a few things. And you know what? Another thing I kind of wanted to talk about, we'll probably talk about it next time we have on the show, how they tore down that building, the Sound Philadelphia building.
Yeah.
And I'm sure he could have gave us some insight on that.
Yeah.
But I'm just kind of upset at Philly because why do we sell these iconic buildings and landmarks, you know what I'm saying, to tear it down in the name of blah, 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 whatever.
Yeah, because isn't that small, I used to walk past it every day
on
Broad Street.
Okay.
Where Gamble and Huff used to have their little...
They tore that building down.
That's the building they tore down.
They sold it and tore it down. And it was a hurt piece.
What's there now?
I'm not sure what's there. It's hard for me to walk by there now, so I haven't seen it in a minute.
You know what? We drove by it and didn't even know.
Yeah, man. It's like Philly. I mean, we got a lot of rich history here. And you talk about music. Mm-hmm. When we had Carla on, remember we had Carla Robinson?
We
talked about the Uptown.
Uptown
go hand in hand with Soul Records and the Sound of Philadelphia.
Yeah.
We had James Brown perform right here in Philly. We had the OJs.
Yep.
We had the Splinters.
Yep.
We had, and then of course, as it moved into our era, New Edition, Run DMC, and all them at the Uptown. So we got to stop tearing stuff down. We
got
to have them both back on.
She has to give us the update on the theater that she was trying to, you know, revitalize.
Okay,
remember that?
Right.
So we have to give, her back on.
And I would like to get Rob's take on the Uptown, because I'm sure he can speak on that, and he can speak on the Sound of Philadelphia, the tearing down of the building, blah, blah, blah. Now, from when we last talked to Carla, they're trying to
trying
to build it back up.
We got to have her back on to see where they are in those in that process. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I also heard? Now, I don't know how true this is, but you know those little plaques on the ground as you're walking up Broad Street.
Right.
I heard they want to take them up.
They want what? See,
that's what I heard. Now, I don't know how true that is, but I did hear that they were trying to see how they could take that up, because what they were trying to do was revitalize the whole area.
Okay.
So I have to find out from Rob, you know, how true that is and if they're still going to do that. But I did hear something around, you know, that they wanted to take up the little musical plaques off the ground that had all the artists' names on them.
They
wanted to take them up because they'd be like, people are just walking on them. No one's paying attention to them.
Right.
So they were saying that they wanted to take them up. But I hope not.
I hope not.
You had already tore down the building. Now you want to take up the plaques.
What is going on? I mean, come on.
I hope
Patti
not.
LaBelle.
Yeah.
Gladys
Patti's,
Knight and the Pips.
Their
come
names
on,
are down there.
Come on,
so
now.
It's like, leave that alone.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I hope they're not going to take those plaques up. And remember, he was talking about Gamble and Huff and the revitalization of South Philadelphia.
Yeah,
I grew up in South Philly, I grew up down there. So it's beautiful down there now.
Yeah,
it's beautiful. So, you know, I wanted to, you know, when he come back on, we're going to talk a little bit about that, because he has worked to build up that area.
Yeah. And if there's anybody that would know, he would know, because he's been connected with that. And so, man, it was another great interview, man. I'm just sitting here as, you know, I don't know, man. I'm just sitting here absorbing.
There's so much rich musical history here that we should not be getting rid of it
like that.
You know what I mean?
Right. And he was throwing out the different dances and all, and the song. And see, I learned about all those songs because my mom and dad played them in the house when I was little. And so we learned about the OJs, the Splinters, you know, the Intruders. You know, we go on and on about the, of course, Marvin Gaye and all that because they played that. And you know what, Nick? Remember when we interviewed Mr. Leon at the Uptown show?
Yes.
After the show. And he mentioned something that's very true. And I'm sure when we bring Rob and them back on, I'm sure he's going to test it. The music set the tone for the era of life.
Yes.
And you know what? That music was the voice of the people.
Yes, it was.
You know, James Brown, say it loud, I'm black and I'm proud.
Yeah.
They had songs that were singing, that they were singing that was talking about getting out and voting.
Yeah.
Police brutality.
What's going on?
Yeah. Joblessness, homelessness. Mm-hmm, so we have lost that, because now if this music of this generation is the voice of the people, it's about slap your mom,
punch your girlfriend
in the face. Girls is bees and holes, and go rob this place and run up in this joint. Mm-hmm. It's no social consciousness no more.
Yeah.
And Soul Records, the Sound of Philadelphia, the music of even the rap music, KRS-One,
yeah,
Rakim,
yeah,
you know, Boogie Down Productions, yeah. They were all social conscious. They were not only bringing awareness, but that music, it was a good flavor. Yeah. It brought back good times, because I remember even just mentioning to my mom and dad, my dad listened to the show and we had Carl, and he was like, "Kev, y'all was taking me back." And I remember the Uptown, and that's when they had gangs. But during the Uptown, nobody was fighting.
That's right.
And you had rival gangs that were sitting next to each other.
That's right.
In the Uptown, everybody was dressed nice, had their furs on. I mentioned to my mom. Oh, she was like, "Oh, that was back in our day."
Yes, you could
hear the happiness in her, you know, in her voice as she explained it. And that's what that music did.
And I loved when we went to the Uptown, when we went to that play, I loved seeing the seniors get up and
dance. They were dancing in the aisles.
Yeah.
That was
getting up and dancing, because they remember
that time.
And shout out, I got to do this, shout out to Ernie B and the New Blend for keeping that alive.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
They got their gospel quartet going on, but also for keeping, you know, the soul alive. You know what I'm saying? Because they have that as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they were also in the Uptown, but shout out to Ernie B and the New Blend, because, you know, they also keep the music going, keep the history going.
And we got to add to that, shout out to Carla Robinson and all the actors and actresses that were in the Uptown for keeping that theme alive.
Yeah,
you know, she's
you know
fighting,
what? They all get the bell. Keeping that alive. You can't forget about that. You cannot let that die.
Absolutely.
That's history. You cannot let that die down.
And you asked the perfect question, Nick, when you asked Rob about, do you educate your artists on the rich history of our music? And Rob answered it perfectly. Look, everybody gonna get this on the back of your CD. We're gonna give you this information so that you understand. Because how can you
They gotta know.
Yeah, how can you go where you go where you're going if you don't know where you come from?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So it was just great, man. It was just great. Yeah, great interview. Great guest, man.
Yeah.
And just so proud of our guests, so proud of our show, and just so thankful that they took time out of their busy schedule, because they always busy.
Always.
They always busy.
He stay busy.
And you know what? You know what else we could have missed?
If he ain't on the phone doing deals, he on Facebook.
He stays somewhere and posting pictures about where he at. And most of the time they be at some restaurant doing business deals. So Rob be doing his thing, man.
He stay busy.
And then I failed to mention too that he's gonna be doing some scores for some movies.
Yeah.
So we forgot.
We can't get that away.
Yeah. We can't get the movies.
He's gonna be doing
the score, or putting, you know, the director in contact with some artists who gonna be doing the score. So Rob, we had the
privilege of seeing some of that powwow going on about the score. So I'm excited about that.
I'm just excited. So yeah, man.
Yeah.
Another great show, great guests, and we looking forward to having them.
They all get the bell again. Yes, another great show. That was a lot.
And I'm going to tell you, I know who are really going to enjoy this show, our old school listeners.
Yes.
They're going to enjoy this.
Because
they're going to be able to identify with the Uptown, Soul Records, Soul of Philadelphia, Gamble Hub. They're going to really enjoy this. And then it's going to educate the young generation. But you know what, Nick? I was really grateful that I look at us as tweeners. Mm-hmm. We're in between that old school and new school.
But I'm going to tell you right now, I'd rather be with the old school.
I'd rather be with the old school stuff.
I mean, I just don't understand it.
Yeah.
I can't get, you know, I'm not saying anything about, you know, the artists or anything like that.
Some of it, you know, go too far.
It does. So I'd rather be with the old school. I'll throw in some old school in a minute, so it don't matter.
Yeah.
You know, if you ask me, Nix, what is your choice?
What's your
old school?
Old school.
I go
with old school rap, old school soul music.
Yes.
I go with old school.
Old school all the way. Absolutely. All the way. All the way. Absolutely. You know, these new ones can take a little lesson from the old. That's why they always sample it.
Right. Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's why they always sample it.
And I love that we brought that up, too, because it's like this new generation, there's no creativity. I remember, I think you mentioned it on Carla's show, how back in the day, they used instruments.
Instruments.
And you a fan of instruments.
I'm a huge fan of instruments because I play the drums.
Remember
And I sing as well. So I'm a huge fan of instruments. My father taught me how to play.
Now,
I don't know how to read music, but I play by ear.
Yeah, I got you.
So I'm a huge fan of those bands back in the day. Instruments. All you see, instruments coming out. Earth, Wind, and Fire. Instruments. You know, instruments. Lionel Richie and his boys. Instruments. They don't know how to play these instruments. All they know how to do is just sample.
And like you said, that song from Drake was sample. You know, if somebody, you know, want to sample your stuff, they deserve to get paid. They deserve to get royalties because of, you know, because of copyrights.
Absolutely.
But I'm going to tell you somebody who was from the old school to mid school, who came into the new era, but stayed true to instruments.
Who's
no longer with us, Prince.
Was
he an instrumentalist or what?
Oh my goodness, Lord, man!
You know what I'm saying? Instruments, man. I would die for you.
Instruments.
You know what I'm saying?
Instruments.
And like you said, Earth, Wind, and Fire. You gonna hear them horns, right?
Yep.
Man, we can go on and on about this. I'm telling you.
The hi-hat, the 808.
Yeah.
Instruments.
Instruments.
Listen, they don't know. Listen, I'm telling you, you going back.
Man. I'm going back.
You going back. You about to get this bell. You better stop.
I told you.
I love this. I love live bands.
Live bands.
When they're just playing those instruments, that's what it's about.
That's music.
And remember that rapper, Rel Jerv.
Remember
his listening party. What did this young man do? He brought out the instruments. He brought up the band. He brought up the band.
Yeah, man. Shout out to our guy, Rel Jerv from the Four. Man, his album release party was lit.
It was fire. Because he brought out the instruments. He had the guy on the drums. He had the keyboard going. He had everything. I was like, look at this.
Yeah, he took it.
You don't see that anymore.
Right.
You don't see that anymore. You don't see it.
That's right. Stop all this sampling, y'all.
Our young people need to get back to picking up these instruments. Yeah. I used to play the flute in school.
Oh, really?
Remember back in school when they had the music teacher?
Right.
She was like, pick an instrument.
Everybody
pick up the flute.
Right.
And
like, or the harmonica.
Making all that noise. And then my father bought me a drum set. You know, I had my keyboard, had my microphone stand, the drum. I had everything going into one outlet and the house burned down.
The house burned down anthem. I remember you shared that.
Because I had the keyboard, I had the microphone stand, everything going into one outlet because I wanted everything in front of me.
Okay.
I didn't want to have to walk over to the other side of the room to play anything.
I got you.
So I had everything going into one outlet and I would come straight home from school and you would hear me beating on them drums, playing that keyboard stuff in the house. We had church, the house engulfed in flames.
So you was on your Sheila E. to the house with them flames.
I was on my Sheila E. tip. Every day I came home from school, I was in my room beating them drums, playing on that keyboard and that microphone. I just would be in there because it's that music.
Yeah, it's the music. Yeah.
Went to church one day.
Came home and the house was gone. Oh my goodness. Yeah. But you know something though? I would like to say, this is just a Kevinism. Okay.
I like that.
This is just a Kevinism. This is just a Kevinism.
What?
But it's something that I strongly believe.
What?
If you want to, I'm going to give two barometers to be able to tell where a society is. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give four.
Okay.
How you take care of the kids.
Yes.
How you take care of your senior citizens.
Yes.
The type of music.
Yes.
And I'll go with those three.
Okay.
The type of music. Because it's like the music kind of, it's going to define the time. Oh, the fourth one would be, how are the working class people of that city, how are they behaving?
Mm.
How are the working class people of that city behaving? What is the music that represents that era?
Yeah.
How do you take care of young people and how you take care of your senior citizens? I believe those are four Those are four barometers that you can look at a city, a town, and be able to gauge where it is.
I'm going to tell you right now what my dream is. Mm-hmm. When I make it big as a A-list actress, mm-hmm. my dream is going to be to open up a music school.
Okay.
I'm going to hire the best musicians, and we're going to get these kids up in here, and we're going to teach them how to read music.
Right, right.
We're going to teach them how to play these instruments.
I got you.
That's what we're going to do. I want the biggest music school where it's going to be like from fifth grade, because you got to get them young.
Introduce them young, fifth grade
on up high school, and every year for graduation, we're going to have this big old jam.
Right, I got you. You know, if I had to throw out one of the things I would love to do, I would love to build a kind of comparable to DHS.
My own
facility where I get to handpick the staff.
Yes.
You're gonna be staff that are educated.
Yes.
You're gonna be staff that love kids.
Yes.
Because there's over 4,000 homeless youth in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
And even the system in Philadelphia is not putting a dent in the homelessness in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have it set up where they're going to be able to get educated. If you don't want to go to college, you're going to learn a trade.
Yeah.
But when you come out of my program, you're going to be prepared for life. We're going to prepare you holistically.
Yeah.
We're going to prepare you spiritually.
Yeah.
We're going to prepare your mind. We're going to prepare you emotionally for those that might need therapy or counseling.
Mm-hmm,
we're going to prepare you financially on the value of, you know, maximizing your dollar, saving, how to open up. You know, kids don't even know how to open up a savings account.
I know.
We're going to teach them that, man. Mm-hmm. This is what I want to do. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to have it built, and I'm going to handpick interview every staff myself, because I'm going to make sure that they have love and compassion for these kids, and we're going to get teachers from the best around, and that's what I want to do, man.
You know,
so you're going to have them hooked up with the arts.
Yes.
And then after they graduate, they're going to go over there and learn acting, learn instruments, and stuff like that, man. So it'll be
awesome. And I can't wait to get on that level so that I can open up that school, because our children need to understand.
Yeah.
You know, there is more to life than the video games. There is more to life than going outside and shoot them up, bang, bang, and different things
than
like
your
that.
Hood.
Than the hood and all that kind of. They need to know.
Right,
they
right,
need
right.
to know. And music,
absolutely.
You know, and what you're saying, that's the way to go. So
that's it.
You get the bell.
You get the bell too.
Yeah.
Man, see, we can go on about this. We can go on this about.
See what Robert did.
Robert started something.
He opened up.
He opened up a can of worms.
He opened up everything.
Yeah, we gotta move along, man.
I didn't think we were ever gonna get off. It's Rob's fault.
It is Rob's fault. We're gonna blame him.
Rob, get the bell.
But no, he's doing some big things.
He is.
Man.
He's doing some big things. I'm proud to be connected with him.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm proud.
Absolutely.
Proud.
Definitely doing some big things.
Yes.
Shout out to him and Lauren again.
Yes.
Denny Brown and the whole entire cast, crew, and production of Chase Street doing big things. And look, we're gonna keep them tuned.
We're gonna keep them in tune.
Things start, you know, popping off, we're gonna bring them back. We're gonna talk about it and give them updates.
That's right.
So what we got next?
That was a lot, wasn't it?
I feel like I just had a venting session.
You know what I'm saying? Oh my goodness.
But not in a negative way. You know what I'm saying?
No, that was a lot. See what happens when you bring on good guests. They bring out the best conversation.
They rub off on you, man. That's why, like we talk about, you got to surround yourself with, if you want to be great, surround yourself with greatness. You know what I'm saying?
That's what we do
on the Kevin and Nikee Show.
All right.
So we're going to
take a break. And when we come back, it's going to be time for news and sports.
The Scholar Professional Editing Firm consists of a specialized group of academic doctors, editors, and statisticians that keep doctoral candidates moving through the academic doctoral process by providing one-to-one group mentorship and all-inclusive editorial service that produce writing advancements that result in exponential movement. The scholars conduct line-by-line editing, proof and copy editing, university-specific format compliance, and substantive done-for-you services on the following documents: doctoral thesis, dissertations, capstone projects, research studies, research papers, research proposals, and oral defense preparations and presentations. The Scholars Professional Editing Group keep you moving. And for more information on editorial services, our doctoral's accelerated mentorship program, visit www.thescholarsediting.com. That's www.thescholarsediting.com, or contact Dr. Haynes at 281-315-6053.
All right.
So we are back. We are back. We are back. It's the Kevin and Nikee Show on iHeartRadio and all around the world. All right. So
now it's time for news and sports.
Oh, no. y'all know it's going to be good or bad news by how I say that sports. But anyway, the NBA playoffs has started. It is underway. And our 76ers took an L in the first round. New Jersey Nets beat the 76ers 111. It's the Brooklyn Nets. It used to be the New Jersey Nets. Mm-hmm. They beat the Brooklyn Nets beat the 76ers 111-102 in game one in Philadelphia. All right. So the Brooklyn Nets opened the 219 NBA playoffs with a statement, taking game one from the third seed, the Philadelphia 76ers, on the road, 111-102 at the Wells Fargo Center. The Brooklyn guard trio of D'Angelo Russell, Spencer Dinwiddie, and Caris LeVert continued the success they had against Philadelphia during the regular season, combining for 67 points. The six-seeded Nets took a 17-point lead in the second quarter and never trailed again. The Sixers cut the Brooklyn lead to 2 points with a burst right out of halftime, but the Nets responded to take an 11-point lead going into the fourth quarter and extended that to a 16-point lead, going up 104-88 with 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go and keeping the Sixers at a distance down the stretch. Russell led the Nets with 26 points, while LeVert had 23 and Dinwiddie 18. Ed Davis had a double-double with 12 points and 16 rebounds to go with a stellar defensive effort on Philadelphia center Joel Embiid. Joe Harris added 13 points. Damar Carroll had 11 points for the Nets, who shot 42.3% from three-point range, which is unbelievable. That's awesome. They made 11 out of 26 and 92.3% from the free throw line, going 24 for 26. Now, if you want to win games, you got to rebound and you got to hit your free throws. All right. The Nets built a 17-point second quarter lead on the way to a 62-54 advantage at halftime. Harris knocked down 3 three-pointers in the first 7 minutes to keep the Nets even and counter Embiid's forays to the foul line. Trailing 22-19, the Nets closed the first quarter with a 12-0 run to take a 31-22 lead. Carroll had 7 points in the burst with back-to-back threes from Dinwiddie and Carroll closing the quarter. After Jimmy Butler made 1 of 2 from the line to open the second quarter for Philly, LeVert scored 8 straight Brooklyn points with 2 three-pointers and a drive, making for a 20-1 Brooklyn run. A Russell three-pointer a minute late put the Nets up 44-27. Butler led Philadelphia push to cut into the lead with 18 second quarter points, including a buzzer beater three-pointer that made it an 8-point game at the half. The Nets held the combination of Embiid and Ben Simmons to 2 for 14 shooting in the first half, though Embiid did get to the line to make 9 of 11 free throws, but overall the Sixers shot 16 for 48, that's 33.3%, and 2 for 14, which is 14.3% from three-point range, which is not going to get it done. While the Nets made 8 of 15 three-pointers, which is 53.3% in the first half. So Philadelphia opened the third quarter with a 9-3 run to close within 65-63 before the Nets responded with a Davis rebound basket and 2 Russell scores to extend to a 71-65 lead with 7 minutes 30 seconds to go in the quarter. So with the Sixers still within 73-70, the Nets outscored them 18-8 over the next 6 minutes with 2 Carroll free throws, putting Brooklyn up 91-78 with 1 minute 27 seconds to go in the quarter. The Nets took a 93-82 lead in the fourth, leading 95-86 in the fourth. The Nets put together a 9-2 run to extend their lead to 16 points. Dinwiddie sandwiched a pair of drives around LeVert's three-pointer and Russell's mid-range jumper, put Brooklyn up 104-88 midway through the quarter, and after that, they never look back. Game 2 was this past Monday night in Philadelphia at 8. I don't know if I want to continue to cover this story. But so we just make mention that it was played. You know, I'm not.
Wow. Oh, you feel bad.
But here's the thing. I would say this. As bad as they played in game 1, there were a lot of times when the game was still close. Mm-hmm. And that can be a good sign when you're not playing well, but you're still in the game. So, we'll see. We're going to keep hope alive, and I'm believing that the Sixers are going to pull it out at the end.
Yeah.
That's all I got in sports.
All right, we'll see what happens. We'll see.
We got to get Joel Embiid to stay healthy.
How about that? Well, in news, last week was the celebration of life for Nipsey Hussle. And what a celebration it was. I mean, the Staples Center, 21,000 people filled that place, and it was still people standing outside. I mean, it was huge. Then there was, from the Staples Center, they took him all around the city, a 25-mile drive through the city to, you know, his last victory lap, as they call it, all the way over to the Marathon, his clothing store. And let me tell you, you couldn't get through. You could not get through. It was so many people out there that just wanted to say goodbye, wanted to just lay their hands on the hearse. Okay. On the hearse. Mm-hmm. They were throwing flowers up on top of the hearse. I mean, it was just touching and beautiful. Right. Just touching and beautiful. The councilman of Los Angeles, Marquis Harris Dawson, they named the intersection of Crenshaw Boulevard and West Slauson Avenue to Ermias Nipsey Hussle and Agadon Square.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
Wow.
That Ermias Nipsey Hussle and Agadon Square. Yeah. Nipsey Hussle, real name, birth name is Ermias Agadon.
Yeah.
And I mean, It was just awesome. Yeah. It was just beautiful. And they had, the scripture was read by Minister Reed Rich. Mm-hmm. Scripture was also read by Pastor Shep Crossford, a selection by Frank Sinatra. They played Frank Sinatra, My Way. Yeah. They played that performance by Marsha Ambrosius, Fly Like a Bird. Acknowledgments and Resolutions by Karen Civil. She is his business partner. Mm-hmm. Performances by Anthony Hamilton, Do You Feel Me? The kids did a beautiful tribute. Some of them, you know, were a little emotional, the children. Some of them didn't want to speak. But Imani Agadon, Cameron Carter, Khalil Kimball, and Cross Agadon. They also did, you know, they said some things. Then a performance by Janibe Akio, Eternal Sunshine, and more remarks. The obituary by Adam
Andabram,
and the eulogy again by Pastor Shep Crawford. Mm-hmm. And then you had Snoop Dogg said some things.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg got up, he says some things, and Lauren London herself says some things. Nipsey's mother said some things, his father, his brother, sisters. Everyone just got up and just shared their beautiful tribute.
Yeah.
You know, to Nipsey. And also Louis Farrakhan.
Oh yeah, yeah.
He got up and he said some things. I mean,
Barack Obama sent a letter. Yeah.
Sent a letter which Karen Civil read.
Right, right.
You know, and Snoop Dogg made mention of the letter. And it was just moving and beautiful.
And you know what, Nick, just, you know, by way of comment, Nipsey Hussle is no longer with us physically. But when, as T.I. said, when you're operating on a higher vibration, the person was taken from us.
Yeah.
But you can't kill an idea. You can't kill a philosophy. You can't kill, because an idea is left behind. A philosophy is left behind. And Nipsey left behind a philosophy about entrepreneurship. He left behind a philosophy about community, building up the community. He left behind an idea. He left behind his music. Mm-hmm. His music gave a philosophy.
Yeah.
His music gave an idea.
Yeah.
And so, we think about all this envy and jealousy and the fact that he was taken, you know, from this world. But you cannot kill an idea and a philosophy, a voice that was left behind.
And you know what? To your point,
Louis Farrakhan said it so plainly. Mm-hmm. He gave out the meaning of Nipsey's name, Ermius. He said,
God will rise.
God is rising.
Yeah.
Then he said, Nipsey means this. Nipsey means homie. Mm-hmm. Then he said, it's homie is a brother from the hood that never really left the hood.
Right, right.
But now the whole world will embrace him as his life and his death change the hood and produce a profound change in the world.
Now, isn't that what I was just saying about how you can't kill an idea or a philosophy or a voice? I did get a chance to hear his dad speak a little bit. I watched that. Mm-hmm. I heard his sister speak. I heard Lauren mm-hmm. London speak. Mm-hmm. I heard his brother speak.
Yeah.
And I did get a chance to hear Snoop speak.
Yeah.
I didn't get a chance to hear Farrakhan speak, but what you're saying is tied directly in what I just said. He might have been taken from us, but his voice will never be taken from us. His idea, his philosophy that he mm-hmm. left mm-hmm. behind, because as Lauren London said, the marathon will continue.
That's right.
So, so in essence, did the envy and jealousy or whatever spark this, you know, her tragic mm-hmm. Behavior, did it really take away?
That's right.
It did.
That's right. Because the theme that they want everyone to take away from the from Nipsey's life is to be a new man and a new woman and celebrate unity.
Right, we saw
that with the, you know, the gangs, so many of the gangs, they came out together. They came out and they band together to show the world, hey, it's about change.
And you know something, you know, Nick, and you know, depending on who you talk to, they're going to have their different perspectives mm-hmm, about who mm-hmm, Nipsey is. Mm-hmm. Some people are going to choose to focus on his gang life. And I'm not condoning any negativity or bad things that might have been done in the name of gang life. Nobody's mm-hmm. not saying that. Mm-hmm. What we are saying is that, as I said in Kevin's Corner, everybody can change. Like Rocky said, if you can change, then everybody can change. And that's we see evidences of his change.
Yeah.
And then he started empowering people.
Yeah.
You know, he built the whole block and was hiring people and in the name of entrepreneurship and mm-hmm. creating jobs mm-hmm. and opportunity in the neighborhood that he grew up. Yeah. He owned his own masters of his music.
Yeah.
That was something that Prince was trying to tell, artists about earning your own masters. So this guy, you know, was a self-taught entrepreneur and it was working.
Yeah.
At least, you know, in the latter half of his life. And, mm-hmm. You know, so depending on who you talk to, some people will choose to focus on his past and never let him live it down and label that as who he is, as a gangbanger or whatever. And some people are going to say, hey, while we're not condoning that, hey, this guy made changes he empowered people around him and he was positive or he became positive.
Yeah.
And so it definitely is a moving, touching story, man.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
And like Snoop said, and you just said it, Nick. Snoop said, hey, Nip, don't you know you're making music with rival gang members? Mm-hmm. The game is from a rival gang member.
Yes.
And yet the game went off upon hearing about him being killed.
Yeah.
Now you have to be somebody to bring historical gangs.
Yeah. And from what I understand, those two gangs in particular mm-hmm. have not come together in over 27
years.
In over 27 years, they have not come together. And look what this man was able to do.
Right.
And I'm going to end my news with this. Mm-hmm. In the words of Samuel Ashkadom, stand up for what you believe in, put your money where your mouth is, and never fold.
We can go to break.
That's
on that.
It. That's it.
We can go to that. And nothing else
stand
to be said.
Stand up for what you believe in. Put your money where your mouth is and never fold. And that is the lesson that Nipsey taught.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Through his life and his
death. Through his life and his death.
Wow. That's powerful.
That's it. That's all I got news
that's
for.
That's it, Nick. We're going to end on that. That's the last word right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what we got next?
We're going to take a break. And when we come back, it's going to be time for
Kevin's Corner.
It is not.
Nah. It's going to be time for my favorite part of the show. We're going to find out what's bothering
me. Yes. It's the Kevin and Nikki Show on iHeartRadio. We're everywhere and we'll be back.
All right.
Sound of Philadelphia.
That's it. And you like you yes. talked about, man, the instrument.
You hear them drums, yeah, and you hear that guitar up in there.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Instruments. We gotta get back. We gotta teach our children how to play these instruments.
I gotta give you a shout out, Nick. You be on the wheels of steel.
People don't understand, man.
It's a lot of work that this is a public service announcement. There's a lot of work that goes into a radio show. And
yes, it is.
You guys have no clue in terms of the promotionals and the marketing and things like that. And I just have to give Nick a shout out between the music. She does the editing for the show. She's like the engineer and all that stuff and much, much more. And so when you guys get the opportunity to hear a smooth show with no niches and glitches, is because she has spent hours and hours of listening to the show over and over, sometimes two and three times, to get all the glitches out. I mean, that's just behind the scenes stuff. So
thanks,
I gotta borrow the bell. You get the bell.
Oh, thank you so much. I love our show.
It has to be right. It gotta be right.
Sound has to be right. Everything has to be right.
Right.
It all has to be right. So I love our show. Yeah, I do. I love our show from the bottom of my heart. I thank God for our show. And it's one of those things that where we didn't know.
We're happy to have it, be a part of it.
Yeah.
Proud of it. And like I said, it just kind of took a life of its own and started going where it's going.
Yeah.
And I like how our show is helping people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, it's like every time we bring on guests that are providing good information.
Yeah.
In addition to Kevin's Corner and What's Bothering Nikki, we're giving out information that's helping people become better actors, or to get cast more, how to get a record deal and things like that. So we're helping people.
We're helping with
the phenomenal guests and then with the information that we share that is building the human being up holistically. And I feel good about that every week, man.
Every week.
I feel good about that every week, that we're helping
every
people.
Every week.
And then we're sharing, you know, our following and fan base with the people that we bring on.
That's right.
Because, and then we get reports and feedback where, hey, Kevin, Nikki, I got cast because the information I applied to your show, or I connected with somebody who gave out a website, and da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And that makes us feel good.
Yeah.
Now, y'all can start sending us commission when y'all get cast. I'm just playing.
Stop it.
But anyway, it is now time for my favorite part of the show. We're going to find out what's bothering Nikki. What's bothering you, Nick?
Well, it's nothing really bothering me because, you know, we had a good week.
Yeah.
And I was too busy, you know, just paying respects and different things like that, you know. But if I can just real quick, I just want to talk real quick about the word love.
Mm-hmm.
When was the last time you told someone you love them? Or did you wait until they're gone to tell them you love them? Did you tell them, did you call them on the phone and say, hey, I love you? Did you send them a text? Hey, I love you. I think that we need to get in the habit of telling our friends and family that we love them.
Mm-hmm.
Last week, we said goodbye to two very important people in my book. One is in the music industry. The other one is in the acting community.
Mm-hmm.
One is white. The other is black. And both are loved, were loved by everybody.
Right,
both touch lives. They both did the same thing. One, I said, is in music. The other one is acting. Nipsey Hussle, he's a musician. Wayne Scher was an actor.
Mm-hmm.
And just looking at the post, everyone just pouring out their hearts about Wayne on Facebook.
Yeah.
It was just overwhelming and beautiful. All of the pictures.
Yeah.
Wayne was on so many sets, countless sets.
Yeah.
And just looking at all of the photographs from all of the sets that he was on and the beautiful words that were shared about, you know, the different things that Wayne said to people, the different sets that he was on with people, and the lives that he touched.
Right.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Just beautiful. And then going over to Los Angeles and just looking at how the people just came out in record numbers. I mean, it was so many people. It was like a blanket of people just coming out and just paying their respects to this man who has touched their lives.
Right.
You know, I mean, just, it was just so much love from both industries, the acting industry, as well as the music industry. Mm-hmm. It was just so much love. And with that, I mean, nothing's bothering me.
Right.
Nothing is bothering me. Just to look at it, you know, it's just, you know, it really did touch me. Yeah, it really did touch me.
You know, like my mom and dad used to always say, give me roses while I'm still alive.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, I've shared this with you, Nick. One of my motivations why I grind the way I do is I'm using acting as an instrument to bring my family together other than a funeral.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to transition this and how it's going to connect with Kevin's Corner. See, I never said that I got into acting for the money. I never got in. I didn't get into acting to be the best actor in Philly. I didn't get into acting to be a multi-award winning actor. I got into acting, I already said that, for the free food, but and for the challenge, you know, playing basketball. Basketball was over. You know, athletes, we need another challenge. But it's to challenge yourself.
Yeah.
But being serious, one of my goals for getting into acting, I sat around and I thought, how can I bring my family together under celebrated circumstances?
Yeah.
Where we can celebrate around food, fun, family, fellowship, and friends other than a funeral.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so that was part of my motivation for getting into acting and why I work so hard, because I want to be able to invite my family to my premiere. Yeah. Where we all can go have fun and it's a celebrated. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I want to be able to invite them to stuff centered around acting. Now, I'm going to transition to how this is going to fit with Kevin's Corner and what the clip we're going to play.
Yeah.
I don't give a rat's behind who think I can act or who I can't. Who think I can.
Say it.
I could cuss, but I'm not because it's a family show.
It's a family show.
So I don't give a rat's behind. See, you people who would say something like that.
You want me to bleep you?
I'm a hold back. I'm a show respect. I don't give a rat's behind who think I can act or who think that I can.
Say it.
And anybody who's thinking on that, you're operating on a low vibration.
Say it.
See, I'm operating on a higher vibration because I have a higher calling and mission to why I'm doing what I'm doing, and it don't require for me to be the best. You see what I'm saying? I'm grinding because I'm creating memories for my family so that we can get together on this side and when they're alive and doing well and I can give them roses and tell them that I love them while they're here, like you said.
Yes, yes.
And so I'm operating on a higher vibration.
That's
and
right.
Then you hear me say this all the time. One of the things why me and Nikki take our acting very, very seriously, a professional approach, is because we're giving a service to the world.
Yeah.
We give people an escape. People are going through suffering and pain. Mm-hmm. Every time you look on Facebook, somebody's sick, somebody lost a loved one, somebody about to go into surgery. And so if I can create a movie and create a character that can bring you happiness, that can bring you joy, to make you not like me, but to take your mind off your pain, your problems, your persecution, your trials, your troubles, your tribulations, then I feel like I've given a good service to the world.
Amen.
I ain't thinking about me being the best actor or what anybody else think in terms of my acting. I'm operating on a higher vibration.
Yeah.
And I don't have time for those people on the low vibration. You stay on that low vibration where you're analyzing who can act and who can't while I'm bringing my family together under positive circumstances, giving them roses while they are still alive and telling them that I love them on this side and giving a service to the world.
Yeah.
As the great Kenneth McGregor said, that's serving the art and serving the art well.
And you know what?
And that's where I'm at with it.
And to your point, that is what Nipsey was doing.
Yeah.
That he was operating on a higher vibration. And here's the thing. That vibration was too high.
It was too high.
For other people.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, the clip we're going to play for Kevin's Corner is going to sum it up.
It was.
It's going to sum it up.
It was too high.
It was too high.
Everybody But what I want you to understand, guys, that everybody can't be on your level.
Right, right, right.
They're not supposed to. Yeah. They're not supposed to. If everybody was meant to be on your level, who's at the bottom?
Right, right, right.
You know
right,
what I mean? Who's at the bottom? Everybody, this grind, this journey, this high level of vibration is not for everybody. And not everybody's going to understand it.
Right, right.
Not
right.
everybody is going to get it. But what you will get.
Right.
Is people who are envious
yep.
and who are jealous.
See, that's low vibration.
That's on the low vibration. That's what you're going to get. The right. higher the Lord takes you,
yeah.
the more envious people are going to come yeah. out, the more jealous people are going to come out. And that is what Louis Farrakhan said.
And T.I. talked about
it. And T.I. talked about yeah. it also. Louis Farrakhan said, when you are on a higher plane,
yeah.
you are flying above everyone else. And the envious and jealousy people are people who don't know
yeah.
how to fly.
Right. That's absolutely.
That's what he said.
And you know what I found out about, what I realized and learned about envious and jealous people? They make comments like this. He think he all that because.
Yeah.
She thinks she all that because. And really, it actually is a compliment turned inside out.
Yeah.
Because by you saying he think he's all that, she yeah. thinks he all that, it's really you yeah. think I'm all that,
yeah.
and you think she all that.
Yeah.
It's a compliment turned yeah. inside out. Jealous people find a way to blame the object of their jealousy and then attack it.
Mm-hmm.
And try to bring it down.
Yeah.
And like you said, Farrakhan and T.I., they said it. They summed it up.
They summed it up so beautifully.
They summed it up.
And I'm going to tell you right now, from both of these brothers, I've learned. Like I said, one is white, one is black.
Right.
But they touch, both of these brothers touch lives of all races.
Right, right.
All races came out and celebrated Nipsey. It wasn't about white or black.
Right.
They all came out. Everybody poured their heart out on right. Facebook about Wayne. Color wasn't even an issue.
Right, right, right.
White and black poured their hearts out about Wayne.
Right.
Yeah. These
it wasn't about what block you lived on.
No.
What hood you came from.
No.
What colors you was wearing.
No.
With Nipsey, they all came together.
They all came together.
That's high vibration.
And for Wayne, they all came together and flooded Facebook. And what I saw was nothing but love.
Yeah.
That's what I saw. Nothing but love. If you are operating on a higher plane, keep on doing it.
Yeah, yeah.
Say I love you and just keep on soaring.
Right, right,
because
right,
guess
right.
what? Everybody is not equipped. Everybody yeah. don't have the equipment to soar what you're soaring, to reach the level that you're on.
Right. See,
everybody don't yeah. have it.
And it starts with your vibration, your attempt to reach
yeah.
your being on a higher vibration or a lower vibration starts with your thinking.
Yes.
See, you got to be careful with people who think about menial things.
Yeah.
Oh, man, yeah. my name should have been first.
Yo.
You know, yeah. stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? They're not thinking
Say
about
it.
The lives I'm going to touch.
Say it. Say it.
You know what I'm saying?
They're just doing.
You know what I'm saying?
They're just doing. You know
that's
what
low
I mean?
Low vibration versus high vibration. And that's what we're going to talk about when we get in Kevin's Corner. We're going to talk about the 10 signs of people that are operating on a high vibration. We're going to turn this thing into a series. After this series is over, we're going to talk about 10 signs that you know you're operating on a low vibration.
Listen.
And if the shoe fits, wear it.
Hello. Ooh. You better stop. I'm going to end it with
this.
I'm
in my bag today.
You are in your bag today.
I don't mean I like this.
You are in your bag today.
I'm in my bag today.
I'm going to end it with this. In the words of Angelique Smith, Nipsey's mother, and DaWitt Askedom, Nipsey's father,
mm-hmm.
celebrate unity and be a new man and a new woman.
Mm-hmm.
Operate in a spirit of love and understand that everybody cannot be on the level that you're on. When the envy and the jealousy comes, in the words of Louis Farrakhan, it is coming from those who have not learned yet how to fly.
There you go.
That's it.
Man, we can go to the clip now.
That's it. All right.
So when we come back,
it's going to be time for my favorite part of the show. Y'all about to get it. Kevin's Corner. When we come back, it's the Kevin and Nikki Show on iHeartRadio. We're everywhere and we'll be back.
Why don't you give us a sense of what you're feeling?
I mean, for real, it's despair, hopelessness. I think I'm disheartened, disappointed, and disgusted. You know, the very people that we all work so hard to try to liberate and uplift are the ones that ultimately, in the end, you know, hope to see our demise. But you know what I'm saying? That's neither here nor there. I think that right now, I'm just focusing on some kind of clarity and understanding. And eventually, man, I know as the days continue to progress, I find it.
You posted something really interesting. Can you explain? Yeah. Can you explain that?
Yeah, I mean, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes, you know, we you know, because of the lack of education, the lack of opportunity, and the lack of experiences in our communities, most of us who are subjected to the confinement of those communities, we operate and exist on such a very low vibration, you know what I'm saying? And we're very remedial in our thinking. So when we see people who operate on a high vibration and who have a lot more fleshed out detailed thoughts, for whatever reason, because they're well read or, you know, because they travel more or because they've experienced more, it's either one or two things that's going to happen, okay? Some people are going to learn from that person and follow them into whatever greatness comes or whatever the opportunities that can exist from that. And then the other half is going to detest the very existence of that person because their greatness upsets all the things that you're not doing in your life. And so every time they come in contact with somebody operating on a high vibration, internally, the things that they aren't doing for themselves and the things that they haven't made happen in their life causes them to be unsettled. And that usually ends up in violence, in senseless violence due to jealousy.
So what you're saying is it's really jealousy and envy.
I mean, I think it's even stronger than that. I think it's even stronger than that, man. I mean, like, I think people just hate not that you're doing something, but the fact that they're doing nothing and you doing something reminds them too much that they're doing nothing.
You're listening to the Kevin and Nikee Show on iHeartRadio.
Mmm. Mm, they're in church. Did he preach?
Listen.
Did he preach?
Y'all, listen. Get this in your spirit. Get this in your spirit. We talked about this last week.
I told you.
Everybody can't go. Everybody can't go with you. And you gotta check your circle.
Yeah.
When people see that you are doing better and better and better and better, and they're not.
Right. They're gonna detest, like T.I. said. They're gonna detest.
Remember, we said do inventory. We talked about this last week. Do inventory of those who are for you and those who are not. You, Kev, gave a perfect example of people who are not. When you say something, oh, I just got this role, or I just, you know, this album, my album, get ready to drop, and they go,
Watch the reaction.
Watch the reaction.
If their immediate reaction isn't, oh my goodness, that's awesome, that's great, oh man, congratulations, and you can't sense that it's coming from a genuine place, you need to be careful.
Listen.
And you know what, Nick? I'm glad we're talking about this again.
Get it in your spirit. Yeah,
because,
please.
Yeah, I wanted to say this last week, and I'm going to say it this week. I'm going to add to what you said.
I actually want to hear that again, but, you know, we got to move on with the show. I'm going to play that again for my spirit when the show is over.
Okay.
Because I got to hear that again.
Yeah, he preached, man. I'm saying he said it, but I'm going to say this, man. I mean, Nick, you hit it on the nose. Not only we got to do inventory of our circle, like what you said, I'm going to add one to what you said. Do inventory who has access to your circle.
There you go.
Because you can't let everybody in.
No, you can't.
You can't, like Nick said, you can't hang around everybody or have everybody hang around you should I say. And then you can't let everybody have access to you.
You can't.
If they're not operating on a high vibration in church, they'll say, you know, like what they say, everybody's giving off something. When you walk into a room, you're giving off, as church would say, a spirit.
Yes.
As T.I. said, vibration.
Yes.
As a spiritualist would say, energy.
Yes.
And it's going to be rather negative or positive. There is no in between.
And it's not, please understand, guys, we're not promoting, what's the word, conceitedness. We're not promoting that. We're not promoting, you think you're better than me. We're not promoting that. What we are promoting
is boundaries. Needed boundaries.
Yeah. I mean, if you are writing a book and you are starting out and you got your ideas and you got your post-its and different things on the wall and on the mirror and different things like that, and you got your friends coming over, if you got someone in your circle that's picking fun of what you got, they gotta go.
Yeah, they gotta go.
Because now that person is starting to show you what they really think about what you're doing.
Right.
And if they always have something negative, can't do that.
Why you want to do that?
You ain't going to get it off the ground. You know, it's hard out here. Get rid of them.
Right,
because here it comes. You said it best. When a person show you who they really are, believe them.
Right. And see, a positive person that's operating on the same high vibration is going to give you all the reasons you can do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
A negative person on the low vibrations is going to give you all the reasons you can't do it. Guess what? The reason is going to sound good.
And what's the first thing? You too old. How you going to get that done? You ain't got no money.
Right, right, right.
You know, like I said, I remember when I was buying my house. Why are you moving all the way out there? Okay. Boop. X. Right. Gotta go. Right.
And you know something? And here's the thing. When we talk about boundaries, you have who's in your inner circle.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Then who has access to your circle?
Yeah.
And then there needs to be boundaries over your mind.
Yeah.
What are you taking in from people? Are they giving you encouragement and inspiration and motivation about your dream goals and aspirations?
Mm-hmm.
Or are they giving you all the reasons you can't?
That's
you need
right.
to get away from a person
That's
like that.
Right.
And it doesn't mean that you're better. It just means that you are safeguarding your dream goals, aspirations, your vision, because everybody can't handle it.
That's right.
And everybody don't deserve
it. That's right. That's right.
Everybody don't deserve it. And so, Dad, we're not, like you said, promoting conceitedness. We're not promoting we think we're better than people. It's higher people on a higher plane are going to be in agreement with what you're saying.
Higher people on a higher plane think differently from everybody else.
That's right. That's
you know what I'm saying? When you're operating on a higher plane, you ain't got to tell everybody everything.
Because guess what? The people who you connect with, they're going to be safeguarding their circle and not giving anybody access and safeguarding their mind from intaking any negativity. So they're not going to think there's anything wrong with what you're doing. Only the low vibration people are going to say, they think they better than people. Nah, 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 nah. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tell you right now, people who operate on a higher level, a higher plane, keep their mouth shut. And when you see it, you see it.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right.
They don't say nothing.
That's right.
What they say, never let your right hand know what your left hand is doing.
Yeah.
People on a higher vibration know. Keep your mouth shut. Handle your business. Make your moves. And when they see it, they see it. It's already done.
Right. And whether you know it or not, you're speaking in terms of a theological position where God says, and I will prepare a table in the presence of your enemy.
Yep.
See, when God exalts you, you ain't got to say nothing.
That's right.
He gonna make sure everybody see you eating from that table.
That's right.
You ain't got to brag. You ain't got to tell everybody. Well, I'm gonna put this out there because I'm gonna make sure they know what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't got to do all that. And when God show you off, He do it the best.
That's right.
And I'd rather wait on that and let Him do it than for me to try to exalt myself. As they say, He'll exalt you in due season.
Yes, He will.
That's what you're talking
about,
man.
That's it. I'm excited. So now it's time for my favorite part of the show. Well, we already got the prequel.
We sure did.
We about to get some more Kevin's Corner.
All right, guys. Listen, you heard what Nick said. You heard what I said. You heard what T.I. said. You heard what we've been saying on other shows. And so, we're going to get into it, man. We're going to do a series again. I kind of like these series because they build on one another and things like that. So we're going to do a series on 10 signs that may be an indicator that you are operating on a high vibration.
Come on with it.
And then when this series is over, we're going to do the 10 signs that may be an indicator that you're operating on a low vibration.
Mm-hmm.
And I may allude to some of those low vibrations as I talk about these positive ones. And I'm going to deal with two each week. Okay. So for starters, one, the in no order, you are emotionally balanced. Mm-hmm. You know, as your energy begins to vibrate at a high frequency, you dwell less on negative emotions such as anger and despair and envy and jealousy, and you let all emotions pass through your mind without affecting your underlying sense of well-being. Mm-hmm. So in other words, you're able to identify that I don't need or want envy and jealousy, mm-hmm. Anger, hopelessness, despair. I don't want that in my thinking, mm-hmm. because mm-hmm. we know that so whatever the man think of in his heart, so is he, so or is so he. Is his behavior.
Yeah.
If I'm operating in my thinking with anger, envy, jealousy, hopelessness, despair, it's going to produce low vibrating That's behaviors
yep.
that are in line with. Oh, he think he better than the people.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So she thinks she all that because she got new shoes.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. Number two, you are grateful for what you have.
Yeah.
As they say in church lingo, what God has for me is for me. And you happy and grateful and thankful not only for that, but you operate in life with an attitude of thankful. Thankful mm-hmm. that you woke up, that you got food on your table,
right.
shoes on your feet, right. clothes on your back. That you may have a job to go to, that you didn't get fired last week.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That, you know, you were kept out of harm's way. Incident, accident. You didn't get hit by a car. We have so many things that you can see, feel, taste, touch, and hear. And as they say, sometimes you may think that you got problems till you go, you know, till you go see somebody. You know, you may be complaining that you had to stand up on the trolley till you see somebody that don't have no legs.
That's right.
You got kids complaining about why I got to do the dishes. The dishes is an indicator that your lazy self already ate. I don't want to wash clothes. I don't want to wash clothes. Da-da-da. That means you got a washer and dryer somewhere in the balance.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to start acting thankful.
Yes,
we But nonetheless,
do.
Instead of focusing on the things that are lacking in our lives, we notice all the good things we have.
Mm-hmm.
We begin to count the blessings in our lives, such as a home, family, friends, food, fun, fellowship, good health, creativity. Additionally, we feed our sense of abundance rather than feeling of envy, jealousy, or lack.
I love it.
We're going to do it two each week, man. And look, we all we're trying to do is challenge you to do a few things. Do inventory who's in your circle. If they're not motivating, encouraging you, and inspiring you, and pushing you closer to your dreams, goals, and aspirations, and making you a better person, they might not need to be there or deserve to be there.
That's right.
Then do inventory who you have access into your circle.
That's right.
Everybody don't deserve access to your circle when you're out vibrant on a high frequency. And then do inventory. What are you intaking? What kind of counsel are you intaking from people? Are they always telling you, yes, you can do it, and giving you all the reasons why you can't accomplish it? Or they're giving you all the what seems to be realistic reasons why you can't?
Mm-hmm.
You might not need them in your circle or allow them to have access. All we're trying to do, gang, is just challenge you to be where you're supposed to be, and that's operating on a high vibration.
That's right.
Eagles fly above the storm, so let's
that's
be
right.
eagles. That's it. That's all
right.
I got.
That's right. That's right. I mean, that's it right there.
That's it.
That's it right there.
That's it.
I mean, listen, as we see, life is too short to be playing around with people.
Right, right, right.
It's too
and,
short.
And we need not risk our lives, especially for mm-hmm. us that are not 20 and 21. Like, you know, when you was younger, you could make a few mistakes and
right.
recover.
Right.
When you start getting older, you ain't got time for loss no
time.
More. You don't got no time for lack nor loss and playing games with people. And get this, who are choosing to stay on a low vibration.
Mm-hmm.
I can work with somebody who might be on a low vibration, but as T.I. said, they're trying to connect with me to come up on a high vibration, and you have a willing mind and a willing spirit,
mm-hmm.
and you're open, and you're willing to look at yourself and mm-hmm. see what you're mm-hmm. not doing.
Mm-hmm.
I can work with somebody like that. But somebody that's choosing to be negative and you want to stay there, you're going to stay there by yourself.
That's right.
Or with the other negative people that want to stay with you.
That's right.
Because we ain't doing it.
That's right.
We're not doing it. And
that's
you
right.
shouldn't either.
And
because
you
you're more you're more valuable than that. And your life is more meaningful. And the world needs what you have to offer.
You know what? It's a lot of bells being given.
There's a lot of bells,
today.
Man. This might be the record, goodness. Man. This might be the record.
There's a lot of bells.
We didn't anticipate this. There's a lot of bells going on this show.
Goodness gracious. But
anyway.
I got a headache.
We got a headache from all the bells, man.
Yes.
But yeah, that's all I got. Another great show.
Another great show.
We gave out a lot of nuggets. Mm-hmm. Great interview. And like we said, we just want to see people thrive on that positive level.
That's it.
That's all we're trying to do.
That's all we're trying to help people.
That's all. Help that's ourselves. It. Help people.
I mean, listen. Get it together, people.
That's
get it.
It
together. Get that's it together. It. I'm trying to tell you. Everybody can't fit on your ship.
That's it.
Everybody can't go. So stop trying to take everybody.
And what was that? That story in the Bible when the men was on that ship. And it was the sun was out. Everything was going well. Then Jonah, who was disobedient to God. He swam.
It was behind him.
Well, yeah, he climbed on this ship, and then as soon as he climbed on this ship, a storm came. The boat start
that's
rocking,
it right
and
there.
They did the math. They said, "Hey guys, wait, let's do the math." Before he showed up, we was cool. We was catching fish.
That's
it was sunny
right there.
And they said, "Look, you grab his arms, and I'm gonna grab his feet. His behind going back overboard."
You best.
And some people, you need to say, you grab his feet and I'm going to grab his arm. We got to throw him overboard our lives. And as soon as they threw him overboard, the sun came back out. The boat stopped rocking. They started catching more fish. And the principle is, anybody can't come on your boat.
Listen.
You don't know what they're running from.
What did you say? They took inventory real quick.
They said, whoa. He cool. He was cool. Sun was out. He was catching fish. Then this dude showed, no. You grab his arms, I grab his feet. And they did, remember you go, one, two, and three. Yeah,
you
man.
Get on my nerves.
Seriously, man.
Wow.
For real.
That's, you know what? See what y'all get when y'all listen to us.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Woo! Yeah, I'm serious, man.
Funny stuff. That is some funny
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, man. That's what, when you said it. That made me think about that. So, yeah.
All right, now, so put it out
there. All right, let's put it out there. So, I'm actor Kevin D. Benton, and we want to thank you guys for tuning in each week. From the bottom of me and Nikki's heart, top, middle, and bottom. Thank you for tuning in each week. We're doing what we do for you, and we can't do what we do without you. And we don't take you for granted. And so I'm going to put it out there. I'm actor Kevin D. Benton. You can find me on Facebook. Follow me and I'll follow you back. I'm on Twitter at Kevin D. Benton. And then check me and Nikki out on YouTube.
Yes.
We got clips up there, commercials, whatever, feature films, short films. And also, the news is going to be in the Real Production Film Festival that we told you about at the beginning of the show. It can't win an award because I'm one of the judges. It'd be a conflict of interest, but they're going to show it. And we're thankful for that.
They're going to show it, yes.
But we're looking forward to Nikki's performance. And what's the name of the title again?
Sleep is for the weak.
Yeah, weak. And that's W-E-E-K.
Yeah.
It's real, real funny. And I saw the trailer.
It's hilarious.
Yeah. And Nikki, you played the teacher, right?
I am the math teacher.
You're the math teacher. Yeah, she did a phenomenal job.
Check
us out on YouTube. Check us out. All right, that's it. I don't know why I said that.
He all excited. See what happens when he do a new series. He get excited. You can find me on Facebook, Nikki Warner, on Twitter, at Nikki Warner, and on the gram. Hello, I'm Nikki. That's spelled H-E-L-L-O-I-M-N-I-K-E. And you can find our show on Facebook, The Kevin Nikki Show, and on Twitter, at Kevin Nikki Show, and on the gram, The Kevin and Nikki Show. It feels so good saying that. The Kevin Nikki Show. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns regarding our show, hit us up, thekevinnikkishow@yahoo.com. You have any questions for Lauren Marie and Robert E. Johnson, hit us up, thekevinnikkishow@yahoo.com. We'll read it to them, give the answer, and read it back and read it on a show. Like we always say, who knows, your letter can be featured on our show.
Yes,
please. We want to see you at everything that we've said, all of the events we got coming up. We want to see your face.
Come out, network
in the place.
Yeah.
Come out, network.
You know, people ask us, well, man, where do you find some of your acting gigs? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we find them on thefilm.org.
Right.
But we get a lot of our acting gigs from going out networking and connecting.
Because
somebody would rather connect with you personally than they would by seeing a Facebook profile.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Because they get a feel for your personality and who you are and blah, 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 blah. And it always goes a longer way.
And I'm going to tell you this before we cut out. Mm-hmm. Clean up your Facebook.
Yeah.
Clean it up. Because when you're going out and clean it up, clean it up. When you're going out and you're networking and you're handing out your resume and handing out your business card, and these directors will look you up.
They're looking on your Facebook page.
They will look you up. They're looking on your Facebook page, and you do not want them to see a whole bunch of nonsense. So before you go out, listen, this acting journey is work. Okay, right. And it all starts with you taking inventory of the people, not only taking inventory of the people you're around, but taking inventory of yourself.
Right, right.
Clean
right.
your
I like
stuff
that.
Up.
I like that.
Clean your stuff up.
You know, I said to one young man, you know, he asked me, hey, Kev, you know, I want to take my acting a little bit more serious. Can you help me? I said, okay, yeah, I sure will.
Mm-hmm.
I said, your first homework assignment is when a director looks at your Facebook page, can they tell that you're an actor?
That's right.
He said, all right, man, I'm going to jump right on it. I'm going to change it. You know, that's somebody you can work with. Mm-hmm. You can, you know what I mean? Because they're willing to listen.
Clean it up.
You're so true. Because remember, with the big Hollywood director that we're going to be working with, the horror film,
what did he say? He said,
I researched y'all before y'all even got here.
You know,
researched y'all.
Let me tell you right now. I'm going to tell you right now, these directors
do not want
no mess.
I'm trying to tell you.
They don't want no riffraff.
And
they
who
don't
said want that? None. Tim Lonnebo said
yes,
that.
Yes, he did.
They don't want no problems. And they're going to judge you by your Facebook profile.
That's right.
So
clean it up.
Clean it up. Keep it professional. If you got a personal one, I would keep it separate.
Keep it separate.
If you need to have a personal one where you want to complain about, you know, the stuff that's going on in the world.
Keep it separate.
All that stuff. Keep it separate because they're looking at your Facebook page, your professional page. And let me say this, guys. And I'm only just saying this to try to help you. Directors got to be able to find you. They're not going to be able to find your rap name.
Oh, Lord.
They're not going to be able to find your rap name. So to each his own. But when they're looking for you, they want to be able to type in something. They want to be able to type in your name as it would be listed on the credits.
Mm-hmm.
The IMDb credits or the credits at the end of the film.
That's right.
If your name is MC Arson, they're probably not going to type that
they
in.
They ain't going to listen.
They're not going to type that in. That's not going to come up in a Google search.
They're not going to put that in
their film. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They're not going to
write
it. Because they might think you might try to set the set on fire.
That may work in the rap world, but in the film industry, that ain't going to fly.
Right. Sorry. Like, he might burn down the production. MC Arson.
You get on my nerves. It's the Kevin and Nikki Show at iHeartRadio. We're everywhere, and we're out of here.
Peace.
So he's leaving the life he's come to know. Ooh.
He said he's going
back to find.
Going back to find.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. What's left of his world? The world he left behind. So he found out his home.
Been listening to the Kevin and Nikki Show on iHeartRadio. Woo-hoo!
Lucky Land Casino, asking people, what's the weirdest place you've gotten lucky?
Lucky? In line at the deli, I guess?
Aha, in my dentist's office. More than once, actually.
Do I have to say?
Yes, you do.
In the car before my kids' PTA meeting.
Really?
Yes.
Excuse me, what's the weirdest place you've gotten lucky?
I never win and tell.
Well, there you have it. You can get lucky anywhere, playing at LuckyLandSlots.com. Play for free right now. Are you feeling lucky? No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.